Question for you. Would you jump on a machine that takes you 0 to 60 in 2.2 seconds? A machine that kicks out over 180 horses.
Yeah, so 0 to 60 in just over 2 seconds. This should be a whole lot of fun.
See if experience or those young guys will take home that world championship today.
We are off and away.
Watercraft, they can reach.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we'd like to welcome everybody from around the world to the Hidden Trail Sea-Doo Pro Watercross World Championships presented by Jetlift. My name is Mike Young, and I'm hanging out with my good friend Mike Remar.
Morning, Mike. How are you?
Man, I'm doing fantastic. We've had some great racing already this week, but today we're going to boost up the volume.
Yeah, you know, we crowned some world champions in the amateur classes earlier in the week, but now it's time for Pro Day.
It is time for Pro Day. We've got 9 total races coming at everybody, plus we've got our second moto of amateur freestyle, pro freestyle. Going to end up today. I'll tell you what, time to sit back and relax, get yourself a cold beverage, because we're going to have a good day today here from Sugden Regional Park.
A lot of folks out there checking things out from around the world. Yesterday we had 60,000 viewers checking us out, and today we're going to try to top that number, Mike.
Fantastic. Well, before we do, though, we're going to start with our opening ceremonies, and we'd like to bring in Brian O'Rourke from Team Faith to bestow a blessing upon this event.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's pray. Father in heaven, thank you so much once again. We say it every weekend when we're out here doing what we love to do, that we truly are blessed. We have the lifestyle that enables us to do this. We have the sponsors and the support of the Pro Watercross Tour to work so hard to put on such a great event for us to enjoy ourselves. We believe that passion comes from you, and we thank you for it. We invite you to be part of our event this weekend, and today we ask that you keep these racers safe and allow us to represent you and our sport in the most positive way possible. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, Brian O'Rourke. And ladies and gentlemen, at this time, if we could get everybody to please stand, please rise, remove your hats, and face the flag, which is located here on the tower. And let's pay homage to those brave young men and women who are overseas fighting for our freedom. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Hidden Trails Pro Watercross World Championships. And guess what? We don't have a classless sport right here. I didn't see one person kneeling. Did you, Mike?
No, I didn't see that at all. And it is time to go off, Mike, as we are prepping for the 10 to 12-year-old junior ski stock, as long as the 13 to 15-year-old junior ski stock as well, our first race of the day. Reminding you folks that there was a changeup in race number 3, so we've got an A and B in race 3. Make sure you pay attention to that.
All right, representing the junior ski stock in the 10 to 12-year-old division, boat number 13. He comes to us from Cooper City, Florida, riding for Broward Motorsports, Judge Motorsports, Exotic Signs, Shoei, Jet Pilot, Wambleton's, I Saw Cameras, Jet Lift, and Thrust Innovations. Boat number 13 is Sammy Neamy.
Out of Port Charlotte, Florida, riding for Wade Chapin, Broward Motorsports, IPD, Action, Jet Ski, and PC Security on 295, Taylor Skellett.
Boat number 296, already with one championship this year, also from Port Charlotte, Florida, Taylor's twin brother, riding for Wade Chapin Power Sports, as well as Action Jet Sports, PC Security, and IPD Graphics. Look out for Hayden Skellett.
Out of Treasure Island, Florida, riding for Jack's Marina Boat and Wave Rudder Rental and Bad Boys Racing. He's riding on some OPP on number 14, Johnny Zimmerman.
And representing the junior ski stock, 13-year-old to 15-year-old division, boat number 425 from Awesomeville, Dawsonville, Georgia. He rides for Extreme Throttle, as well as Atlantic Customs and Troy Sorensen, and folks over at Swillies. That is Wyatt Hayes.
And out of El Dorado, Kansas, riding for 321 Kawasaki, Hurricane Racing, Hydra Turf Fly Racing, and Hot Products on the 721. Give it up for A.J. Lewinstra.
Ah, yeah, time to go shopping for a world title, Mike Remar.
Well, I'll tell you what, we watched Hayden yesterday just rock the house in the 10 to 12 class, but now he's back in the junior ski stock. Now, he pulled the whole shot and checked out. We've got the 10 to 12-year-olds on the inside split, the 13 to 15-year-olds on the outside split, Mike.
It looks like Hayden Skeller with a good jump on the outside, on the outside. Looks like Wyatt Hayes in that 13 to 15-year-old division. Hayden making it stick. Yeah. Looks like Taylor settled in right behind Hayden. Hayden and Taylor were running 1 and 2 yesterday in that third and final moto, and then Sammy Neamy was able to edge out Taylor right there at the checker buoy to take second place in that 10 to 12 stock class.
Mike, check this out. Hayden Skellett just ran a flawless inside split as he has checked out down the front straightaway with Wyatt Hayes trying to close that gap off the outside.
Yeah, two separate classes. We'll try to keep you in tune to who's doing what in each class. Taylor Skellett settles in there in that third place position, followed by A.J. Lewinstra in fourth, and Sammy Neamy rounding out your top five here on lap number one. Folks, you're watching the first race of the day, junior ski stock 10 to 12 and 13 to 15. 1,500 folks already watching on. We'd like to say hello to those of you who are tuning in from around the world. You're listening to Remar and Young up here on the Tower of Power, and good to share time with my old friend.
Thanks, Mike. It's good to be back. I tell you what, if ever it was a time to come back, this is it. We're checking out the Pro Watercross World Championships here in Naples, Florida. Naples has rolled out the red carpet. We've eaten well. We've had good times with old friends, and now we're seeing some hot racing action, which just makes for a great week of racing.
Yeah, I'll tell you, you know, we've been waiting. Actually, I've been waiting since last Friday I got here. I've been waiting for this since last Friday, man, and it's great to have everybody that I've seen on tour all season long coming together for at least one last time this season at the World Championships. Again, special thanks to the Handler family for bringing the World Championships for us.
Yeah, we go back to the racing action. Now, Hayden Skellett pulled that killer hole shot off the inside as he works his way through the right side chicane. Now, Wyatt Hayes, actually in a different class, he's in junior ski stock 13 to 15-year-old, trying to close that gap, but he is actually leading that class. So you're two front runners in the two classes out there in front going 1-2.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, a big shout out to Hayden Skellett, who is out there in front right now. He's actually got his name in the paper today, and the Naples Daily Herald woke up this morning, and his sister's boat's on there, and he was all bummed, but it was somebody else on his sister's boat, so now he's happy again.
Yeah, exactly. You know, there's got to be a little bit of friendly, brotherly, sisterly love going on there with the Skellett family. I know that Taylor doesn't necessarily like losing to her brother, but I suppose if you got to lose to somebody, then your brother's all right.
Exactly. Might as well lose to your twin brother. All right, Wyatt Hayes still in second place. Here comes Skellett, home Skellett, down the front straightaway, working right, left to right in front of you as he'll get the courtesy flags. And I believe here in this one, Mike, that's three laps down and three laps to go.
Well, you know, we look at those top two runners coming through as the race here for third heats up. Taylor Skellett down the front straightaway and 721 A.J. Lewinstra trying to close that gap.
Yeah, by the way, By the way, tomorrow night when we crown those world championships, we're going to be doing so over at the Naples Beach Hotel. Great banquet last year. They're expecting an even better one this year, Mike. I just found out we've got reservations for over 160 people, and our guest speaker is going to be none other than Larry Rippenkroger.
How cool is that? You know, let me ask you this. If we're going to have that banquet over there, will we be able to live stream any of that so folks will check out? Yeah, come on, Rick. Come on, man.
Rick says, man, I've worked myself to the bone this week and a half. All right, here comes your leader once again down the front straightaway. Two more laps to go, and it's going to be Hayden Skellett on boat number 296. And I know if Hayden had the microphone right now, and he did this yesterday, but he would say a special thanks to Wade Chapin, who is hanging out right down here in front of us. One-handed Wade still spinning the wrenches for Hayden Skellett. Once again, he's also sponsored by Johnny Havel and the folks up at Action Jet Sports, his father, PC Security, and then, of course, IPD Graphics. Good stuff, man. Hayden Skellett able to fend off the charges being put on by the 13- to 15-year-old class there in Wyatt Hayes.
Well, I'll tell you what, Taylor Skellett back there, his sister is currently running third in this race. A.J. Lewinster was trying to close the gap on her. He went to that inside split section, and while he did that, Johnny Zimmerman on the 14 machine was able to catch back up and actually make the pass.
That was actually Sammy Niemi. Sammy Niemi that made that pass. It came up into that fourth place position. Now, is Sammy going to get in Taylor's head again?
Oh, that's right. Repeat of yesterday.
Last turn.
Oh, boy.
Last buoy, last turn, last moto. I think Taylor's going to remember that for the rest of her life.
Well, Hayden picking up the penalty buoy down there as he must have missed the buoy on that last lap. White flag out, Mike. Just one lap to go for Hayden as he's picking right up where he left off.
Hayden might be just taking that buoy just for a little insurance. Maybe if he just hit a buoy, he don't want to jeopardize the championship. Very smart young rider. You know, for being 11 years old, he's smarter than a lot of the riders that I know.
And you're right, that's Sammy Niemi. Sammy Niemi goes down there to pick up the penalty buoy as well as he's coming down the front straightaway to see if he can put this thing together.
All right, once again, your leaders. Working their way through the chicanes up there, top right-hand side of the track, and there goes Hayden down the back straightaway, and Wyatt Hayes will follow suit. Once again, glad to have Wyatt Hayes here as well. We'll talk a little bit about him in just a moment. There we go. Wyatt Hayes out of Dawsonville, Georgia. You know who is out of Dawsonville, Georgia?
Who's that, Mike?
Awesome Bill, man, from Dawsonville. Don't you remember that? Bill Elliott.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
On the Coors number 9 car.
Well, off this outside split section, just one more buoy to go for Hayden Skellett. Hayden out of Port Charlotte, Florida, run for WCP, Action Jet Sports, PC, and Security IPD, picking up that checkered flag and the win in this qualifier.
Home Skellett taking a win. Out of Port Charlotte, Florida, again riding for Action Jet Sports and Wade Chapin Performance. Wyatt Hayes coming through in that second place position, riding for Swillies Extreme Throttle and Atlanta Customs.
And Taylor Skellett getting a little crazy here. She slid out on this last outside split, but able to put it back together. That's going to give her the third overall. She'll finish second behind her brother in the 10 to 12s.
Guess what Taylor Skellett didn't do that time? She didn't look back. She did not look back that time. And Mom breathes a sigh of relief down here in the pits. All right, once again, that was race number one. Race number two is coming up next, Mike. And what do we got coming up next here?
Well, it looks like it's going to be Pro-Am Runabout Superstock. We did a little bit of switching around this morning to make things work a little bit better in the layout of the day. So Pro-Am Runabout Superstock going to be the next race down on the line. Back by popular demand, Vince is in the house.
Trey Frame coming to the line. And I believe he is scared off the competition, Mike Remar.
Well, that's what I was wondering. Looks like, you know, you get to know these racers after a while. And I think maybe he has scared off the competition. Now, Mike, I got to tell you about something. And racers and folks and pit personnel, you got to hear this because I heard a rumor. I heard a rumor.
Uh-oh.
And I believe it's very, very, very true. I heard a rumor that next year for this event, Pro Watercross has over $100,000 to give away next year for this event.
Yeah, that's right. They've already, they're in the process of closing the deal on that sponsorship package, and $100,000 in cash, not in cash and prizes, cash.
Who likes cash?
He said he's even going to possibly pay some of the novice classes next year for coming out.
Yeah, I had heard that. Well, they're going to snap the band on this one, Mike. And Trey Frame out there out of Charleston, West Virginia, run for Hidden Trails Motorsports, one of our sponsors, the primary sponsor for this tour. Blackstar DEI, Jet Tribe, Riva, and Engine Tech Superchargers, his sponsors.
And Trey going to go out there, burn some fuel real quick before we go with race number three. And with that being said, race number three needs to start working their way up here. That is the race 3A Pro-Am Ski Stock. Pro-Am Ski Stock, your qualifier. We need you to the starting line. Pro-Am Ski Stock, we need you to the starting line. Thank you. Once again, race number 3A. Race number 3A, we need you to the starting line.
That reminded me of some flash dance stuff going on right there, Rick.
I thought it was raining men.
Having a good time up here in the Tower of Power. As we're about to call race number three. Now, in race three, we've got an A and a B division, so we're really going to turn that into two races.
Yeah, A is going to be the Pro-Am Ski Stock. Boat number 10, Callaway Turner, Gage Schoenherd on the double deuce, 51, David Cabrera, Sophie Perrin on 296 and 721, A.J. Lewinstra. Need to report to the starting line.
Didn't we just see A.J. Lewinstra run? Boy, he just ran a race. Hopefully that kid's the Iron Man. He's able to go virtually back-to-back here.
Yeah, rode a couple races earlier this week as well. Been racing every day this week. He's probably one of the only riders that's actually raced every day this week.
Well, there you have it. We need to have race number three down online. Pro-Am Ski Stock. Pro-Am Ski Stock should be down online.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, I got my hat's off to the holders there for Trey Frame.
Yeah, did you see how many RPMs he must have been at like 10,000 R's before they even let him go.
That was the best hole shot I've seen all week right there. That was the jet lift hole shot of the week. Trey's so confident that he won that he didn't even go to tech. Once again, we need race 3A, Pro-Am Ski Stock to the starting line. Pro-Am Ski Stock to the starting line. Hey, Mike, while they're coming to the starting line, we got some of this Jet Renew dry wash to give away.
Yeah, that sounds fun. Let's give away some of the dry wash here. You know, we got the spec sheets on some of what they have going on here. And that dry wash, they've got the stank away. They've got all the good stuff you need to make your machine look and smell pretty.
That's right. Well, I'll tell you what, we've got a couple of these to give away right now. You want one? There we go. Little Jet Renew, proud sponsor. Again, remember to support those who are supporting the sport. We'll get grab a couple of them here to give away. You want some free dry wash? This will set you back about $15 at your local dealership. But we're giving it away for free right now. Next five people come up. We've got free Jet Renew dry wash. And again, special thanks to everybody for coming out. Don't forget, we do have Abaco sunglasses. We got the same deal down there, Abaco, as last week. Abaco sunglasses, 2-for-1. They're polarized sunglasses. And you see what I was wearing up here. I still got my Abacos up here. But let me tell you what. They're 2-for-1, only $30. That's right. You can take you and your sweetie up a pair for only $30. All of them are polarized. The ones that I like the most, though, are the ones that they're made of bamboo. And they float. How about that? They're not bombers, but they still float.
Nice, a little bamboo sunglass action going on. And you know, I just heard too that we're also selling some of the Jet Renew stuff at our booth down there, the Pro Watercross booth. You can pick up some of those Jet Renew products if you weren't lucky enough to be one of the catchers of the free product we're throwing away up here at the Tower of Power.
That's right. And if you need a little more pep in your step, then stop on over to Shark Energy. Obviously, I had too much Shark Energy as I just kicked my chair off the off the stage. But hey, stop on over to Shark Energy. They're giving free samples right over beside the camera tower just to the right of the stage. Man, all kinds of cool stuff going on. Abaco's here. Johnsonville Marketplace is serving up brats. We got Shark Energy here. The Pro Watercross store, or Pro Watercross merchandise store, is open. And Rita's down there. They've got t-shirts for $15 a piece or 2-for-$30 all day long.
Our friend Rita down there. Now, I want to call her lovely Rita Meter Maid, but I can't because she's a major and she's bad to the bone.
She is bad to the bone.
Speaking of being bad to the bone, she cut her finger right to the bone the other day, and she's sporting some stitches.
I thought she was just saying we were number one.
Right.
Thank you, Major. All right, so once again, our Pro-Am Ski Stock Class working their way to the line. I see Callaway Turner down there. I see Gage down there. I see AJ down there. I see Sophie Perrin down there. Who don't I see? I don't see Dave. Oh, there's Dave Cabrera.
I say, here comes Cabrera now.
Hey, while we're waiting on that, Mike, why don't you do a quick interview here with Taylor Skellett is up here on the announcing tower, folks. Just took a third in that last moto, second in the 10 to 12 class.
Taylor, now what I want to know is you're kind of famous today as you were right there on the paper in Naples. They did a nice write-up on you and your brother and your family. They have a picture of your ski. Now, I know it's not you, but what's it feel like to be kind of famous here in Naples today?
It feels really good because then everyone gets to really know us. And then, you know, like they all come up and they say good job after a moto when you get second, first, or third.
Now, let me ask you this. We watched that last race, the 10 to 12-year-old stock. You got a pretty good start, but your brother Hayden got a better start. Is that all right with you, or are you going to try to do something about it in the next moto?
I think the next moto tomorrow, I think I'm really going to beat him in that race because I'm kind of getting a little upset not getting first.
And let's go to Hayden then real quick because he's right here as well. Hayden, you think your sister's got a game? Sounds like she's talking a little bit of smack.
Yeah.
He said, yeah, going to let his actions speak for himself instead of those words?
No, because it all out on the track.
It is all out on the track. And can you guys give a shout out to our camera real quick? Because we got a lot of folks watching out there on 24/7 live streaming. Can you guys wave and say shout out?
Hey.
All right, thanks, kids. I appreciate you coming up. Mike, we're down here looking at our third race of the day. Looks like it's going to be Pro-Am Ski Stock, race 3A.
All right, race number 3A, as you pointed out, is coming up first. And down online, boat number 10 from Apex, North Carolina. He'll be riding the top of Kawasaki for Hurricane Racing, Amsoil, and Chatham CNC. That's Callaway Turner.
And out of Clearwater, Florida, riding for Riva Racing, HydroTurf, Clearwater, MortgageBroker.com, and Team Screen 22, Gage Schoenherr.
From Miramar, Florida, riding for Broward Motorsports, Team Mean Racing, Wet Sport Racing, as well as Exotic Signs and Wambleton's 51 is Speedy Cabrera.
And out of West Palm Beach, Florida, riding on the 296, Sophie Perrin.
Sophie Perrin, that's it, and 721 out of El Dorado, Kansas, riding for 321 Kawasaki, Hurricane Racing, HydroTurf, Fly Racing, and Hot Products, AJ Lewinstra.
Well, Mike, it looks like on the inside split section, Cabrera pulled the whole shot. We recognize that boat of his, 51, David Cabrera, and he's also looking really good. I believe he's out there on that Hydra space down the front straightaway. So Cabrera on the 51, 22 Gage Schoenherr, and then the 10 boat of Callaway Turner, 721 AJ Lewinstra, and 296 Sophie Perrin down the front straightaway, rounding out your top five. Cabrera pulled a killer hole shot, Mike.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you what, no surprise there. Cabrera, veteran, and actually raced in the veterans class, did very well in the veterans class a little earlier this week. He won the veterans. Bill Hegg won the masters class a little earlier this week, for those of you who are listening in on the Visit West Virginia live stream.
Yeah, that was a good time, too, watching Cabrera and Hegg that ran those classes together, watching those two guys go at it, taunting each other a little bit. Both great competitors, incredible racers.
Yeah, no doubt about it, and definitely two of the guys to look up to in this sport if you're a youngster coming up and you need advice. Cabrera and Bill Hegg, probably two of the folks that you'd like to talk to.
Yeah, and both those guys, too. I know they train with younger people as they're trying to bring up youngsters through the course and, you know, kind of show them how to play this game, because this is part of the game. It's all about you being one with your machine, having a good running machine, making the right decisions on the race course. As we look at them going through the right side chicane, Gage Schoenherr on that 22 machine, trying to close the gap on Cabrera, but Cabrera just had that great, great start.
Mike, coming up next, we've got race number 3B. That is the Pro-Am Ski Superstock. Pro-Am Ski Superstock, race number 3B. Please work your way to the starting line.
Off that right side chicane and down the back straightaway, Cabrera on that Hydra space, riding for Broward Motorsports, Team Mean Racing, Wet Sport Racing, and Exotic Signs, as well as Wambleton's, doing it up right for his sponsors. Cabrera went through the outside split section last time, and he's going to choose that option again. These racers really starting to spread themselves out as they're equalizing around the track. The real race looks like it's heating up on that back straightaway between AJ Lewinstra and I believe Callaway Turner back there.
Now, Mike, one thing that we need to keep in mind here, that this is a qualifier for tomorrow's CBS Sports Show. And they'll, however they finish up, that's how they'll stack up on the line tomorrow. And for everybody that is listening in right now, or if you're here locally, it's 10 minutes plus one lap in this one here. 10 minutes plus one lap. Actually, that's what it'll be tomorrow. I'm sorry. That's what it'll be tomorrow. So this one here is actually going to be eight laps. Our qualifier, eight laps, 10 plus one tomorrow. Thank you and sorry.
Well, our flagman down there, you know, Nick Handler, putting this one together as some of these races, like we said, are qualifiers for the main event that will be televised on CBS Sports tomorrow. And looking forward to some of those races tomorrow as they will stack up and line up based on how they finish in today's qualifier.
Well, once again, your leader out there riding the Hydra Space is Dave Cabrera. We actually got to see Dave on a Kawasaki earlier this week. It's the first time I had seen him on anything other than a Hydra Space in quite some time. And again, as we pointed out, did very well.
Yeah, he did really well. That machine was sick fast and sick loud. And Cabrera ran it really well. Like we said, he picked up the veteran ski superstock class, I believe, win of the world championship.
By the way, folks, the courtesy flags are up from our tower director, Nick Handler. Signifying here in this Pro-Am Ski Stock Class that it's eight laps down and eight laps to go.
Well, we got a pretty good race picking up right here for that third position between A.J. Handler on 721 and 296, Sophie Perrin out of West Palm Beach, Florida. That battle for third as they work their way through the right side chicane. Here comes 10, Callaway Turner out of Apex, North Carolina.
All right, we made a mistake here. I'm not quite sure why we're so foggy. It was four laps down, four laps to go, and it's A.J. Lewinstra, not A.J. Handler. Well, my goodness, you know, well, I'm trying to multitask here. You know, I'm saying hello to friends around the world, and we're calling the race. It's a qualifier. I'm just qualifying, too, at this point.
Exactly. We're going to bring our A-game for the main event.
Yeah, we're getting all tongue-tied, getting rid of all the mistakes before tomorrow's CBS Sports Show.
We're trying to see where we're going to stack up. Mike, would you like the inside split or the outside split?
Well, I would like a banana split is what I would like. It's hot out here.
Oh, that sounds good. Working their way through that right side chicane. Still, Dave Cabrera on the 51 machine out of Miramar, Florida, doing it up right for Broward Motorsports, Team Mean Racing, Wet Sport Racing, Exotic Signs, and Wambleton's. He's being hounded by Gage Schoenwehr out of Clearwater, Florida, riding for Reva Racing, HydroTurf, ClearwaterMortgageBroker.com, and Team Scream.
Yeah, you know if Chucky has something to do with it, those boats are screaming. Chucky actually came out last year. Chucky from Team Scream, I'm speaking of, came out last year to Tampa Bay to help out Dawson Newby and the Team Faith Arena Cross team, which I thought was pretty special.
Yeah, that's cool. The Team Faith folks are making their presence known in personal watercraft racing as well as motocross racing as well and arena cross.
Two more laps left to go for our riders out there. And Dave Cabrera is still maintaining about an 8.5-second lead over Gage Schoenwehr on the double deuce. But I'll tell you what, Gage has really come a long way this season and went from riding just a sport boat to sport and ski, doing very well. Podium. Actually grabbing a podium spot in Charleston, West Virginia in that sport division, which was a tough class. I mean, that class boasted more riders than any other class on the Hidden Trail Sea-Doo Pro Watercross Tour presented by Jetlift this season.
Well, Gage Schoenwehr, one of the young guns in the sport, too. I actually was talking to Susan Anderson this morning, Mike, and she had done the calculations because she was racing against Gage Schoenwehr yesterday. 36 years separate her and him in age.
Yeah, but not too many seconds when they passed the checkered flag because she was on it late yesterday, no doubt about it. White flag out for David Speedy Cabrera. Again, riding for Broward Motorsports, Team Mean Racing, Wet Sport Racing, Exotic Signs, and my good buddy Wambleton Texera.
So then you have Gage Schoenwehr still trying to chase him down on that right side, but look at the race now back there for third, fourth, and fifth. A.J. Lewinstra has been holding on to that third position all the way through. He's going to run to the inside split section, and it looks like Sophie Perrin going to follow on the 296, whereas Callaway Turner on the 10 boat going to go outside. We'll see how this shakes out, Mike, for that third place.
Yeah, I think Callaway probably made a smart move there. There was nobody out there on that outside split, and he's going to ride up on Perrin right now, and it's going to be a drag race. race between him and Parrott, and he is able to get past Sophie as they work their way onto the bottom right-hand side of the track. Sophie will have position. Oh, Callaway shuts the door.
Nice. Callaway shut that door hardcore over there on that right side, so he was down in the tray trying to make that pump hook up. It really looked like Parrott was going to be able to close it, but no. Callaway carried around the outside and shut the door.
Mike, that's no way to treat a lady. I thought you were supposed to open the doors, not shut the doors.
Apparently not in pro watercross.
Oh, that's right. Pro watercross. Checkered flag out. How about it, ladies and gentlemen? Put your hands together for Dave Cabrera taking a moto number one, actually a qualifier number one winner here. In second place. And now Callaway Turner has his sights set on A.J. Lewinstra with less than a quarter of a lap to go. Callaway gets held up just a little bit. He'll go to the outside, Lewinstra to the inside, and it is going to be tight, folks.
Well, Lewinstra went to the inside, Callaway to the outside. Callaway actually looked back over his shoulder to see where Perrin was, and as they come off that split section to the merge, is Callaway going to have the speed and the momentum?
It could be. Oh, Callaway needed about 30 more yards.
A.J. Lewinstra able to hold on to that third position in that one.
So Callaway ends up in fourth, Sophie Parrott in fifth. And that's the way they'll stack up for their qualifier for CBS Sports tomorrow. Pro-Am Ski Superstock is coming up next. And just a couple riders in that one there. And we're going to take a short pause for the cause. But before we do, don't forget, you can pick up your scissor stand down there at Jetlift right here with us today. Retails for $185. Go on down there and a Pro Watercross World Championship special. All you got to do is say, happy belated birthday, Brian. And they'll sell you one for only $150, Mike. That's $150 holla.
Yeah, that's a great deal. And Jetlift, you know, one of our presenting sponsors here. Also, they got the Jetlift two-wheel beach tote down there. Usually retails for $785. They're letting that thing go with the World Championship special for $625. That's awesome.
Oh, my credit card's going to be burning up this weekend. Again, I'd like to say a very special thanks to all our friends from Jet Renew. Man, they've got the anti-fog, the C1, which is the all-in-one. It enhances the color, protects the finish. It's a spray-on, wipe-off, non-toxic, biodegradable cleaner. You got the C3 sealer wax, the Pink Plus. Man, they've got all kinds of stuff at Jet Renew. And we've got a bunch of their goodies to give away up here. And we will throughout the day. And again, I'd like to say a very special thanks to proud sponsor Jet Renew, Hidden Trail Sea-Doo, Pro Watercross World Championships, presented by Jetlift. Mike?
Well, we're switching it up here. We're going to Pro-Am Ski Superstock. Got a couple of competitors in here out of Treasure Island, Florida, riding on the Callaway for Jack's Marina Boat and Wave Rental, Bad Boys Racing and Riva Racing on 14. Give it up for Pete Kaczynski.
And boat number 79, he comes to us from Sarasota, Florida. He'll be riding atop a Kawasaki sponsored by Wade Chapin Performance and Action Kawasaki Yamaha. It is Tony the Tornado, Cantalamesa.
So we watched Cantalamesa race earlier this week, Mike, and I do believe he picked up a world championship already this week. So he's looking to see if he can put something together here in Pro-Am Ski Superstock here on Pro Day number one.
Well, I'll tell you what, they got two all-star holders down there, too. Lewis Malone will be holding for Candela Mesa and Robert Cias, who runs the stay-and-play up there in Clearwater Beach. We were talking about that the other day. He'll be holding for his cousin, Pete Kaczynski. If you ever go to Clearwater Beach, man, I'm telling you, you can stay and play at the stay-and-play. Right across the street from the world's most beautiful beaches there in Clearwater Beach. Sits right there along the canal. You get fish right off the dock right there, man. Nice pool, jacuzzi. They got it all to stay and play.
Wow, that was some props right there. Good job, Mike.
That'll be
a lot of buddy.
That'll be one free night. Robert actually hooks me up when I fly out of Tampa Airport. He has me stay there if I have to fly out too early. So he takes care of me. I got to take care of him.
That's super cool. Well, Mike, this one is a moto format. So this one's actually going to be moto number one. Moto number two will come at us later this afternoon. We've got one ski on the inside split, one ski on the outside split, and they are both hard charging, trying to pick up that hole shot.
Yeah, just so those of you know who are listening in on the Visit West Virginia live stream that we will be running some motos and some qualifiers, and we'll try to stay on our toes as announcers to let you know which ones are qualifiers and which ones are motos. And as Mike pointed out, this is a moto.
Cantalamisa off the outside, split section, able to carry the momentum as they go down into the front straightaway and to that right side chicane. Cantalamisa able to pull the whole shot, Mike.
Well, I'll tell you what, these two ain't playing around, though. There might only be two riders out there. But did you just see them side by side on two separate occasions coming down that front straightaway and going into that big turn over there on the bottom right-hand side of the track? Now Cantalamisa popping out just a little bit. Cantalamisa already with one world title this earlier this week.
Yeah, Cantalamisa looks good. You know, they came off the split sections. Kosinski off the inside, Cantalamisa off the outside. And it really looked like Kosinski was going to have just enough to be able to eke him out as they went into the double reds at the end of the straightaway. But Cantalamisa carrying all that momentum.
Well, I'll tell you what, these two both part of that Skyway crew that goes up there and practices together at the Skyway and over there at Markham Park as well. Got a lot of respect for each other. And Pete, what I was getting at was Pete Kosinski, when he came from that inside split, he could have taken him way outside. He could have taken his line right away. But again, a lot of respect amongst these two riders, and they're not going to ride like that. Not here, not today, not this weekend, not this year, not next year.
Yeah, well, that's probably a good thing for Cantalamisa, because if we remember correctly, he's already taken a pretty nasty spill. Remember that race a couple of days ago, Mike, where he and Isaiah Washington were coming down that back straightaway attempting the MasterCard buoy, and they got a little together, and they got a little crazy.
Right, that was the day the fog came in for him, and it was only him. He was the only one in the fog out there.
Yeah, that was crazy. He came out of that one, though, probably not knowing what his name was, but he got right back on the machine and ended up picking up a world championship.
Right, yeah, him and Washington had ended up getting together, going through that outside split, battling for position. But Tony the Tornado not having any problems right now, as he's got about a 10-second advantage over Pete Kosinski.
You are currently watching race number 3B, which means we need to have race number 4, Pro-Am Runabout Box Stocks. Pro-Am Runabout Box Stock should be down on the line. Let's go, folks.
This is what wins on Sunday, sells on Monday class, the old box stock division. That's the one the manufacturers are pretty proud of. Cantalamisa trying to turn this one into a snoozer. Again, race number 4, Pro-Am Runabout Box Stock. Jeff Dykowski, Troy Snyder, Tim Ducat, Anthony Rededich, Dylan Osborne, and Brent Venderly. We need you to the starting line. Thank you.
You know, I had a chance to rap at Tim Ducat a number of times this summer. I've run into him at a couple of different events. And both events that I've seen him at so far this year, he has bit a hole in his tongue and cut open his chin. And I'm like, man, what's going on, dude? Is it you just like to kiss your handlebars or what?
I don't know. Maybe the piercing gods are trying to tell him something.
Yeah, I asked him about it earlier this morning. He said this weekend he is not going to bite his tongue and not going to cut his chin open.
All right, fantastic. Well, he doesn't have the waves here on both of those events that that you're speaking of. I think one of them was in Lake Michigan, the other was in the Atlantic Ocean.
So Cantalamisa down the front straightaway, hard charging into that right side chicane, has quite the lead now over Pete Kosinski, as it is green flag racing still underway here for the Pro-Am Ski Superstock. Let you know, folks, that Pro Watercross T-shirt booth is going on down there just on the right side of the Tower of Power here. As you look at the water, those Pro Watercross T-shirts can be picked up for just $15. Get that memorabilia, take it out there, walk around in it. I tell you what, you can be the best sponsor by promoting the events with these T-shirts.
By the way, I'd like to say a special hello to my good friend Joe, who is our television producer down there. Good to see you, Joe, from CBS Sports. Glad to have him back in the house. Went home and probably worked all week. He worked all last week, and I know that. He was walking up and down. This guy spent more time on the beach than Hasselhoff.
Well, and he's not a great dancer, but he must be a better cameraman and film man than that, well, eh?
Mike, you know why you would like him? Joe happens to have something in common with you. He's a Michigan State graduate.
Oh, yeah, baby, MSU. That's what I'm talking about. He's a Sparty. White flag out, just one lap to go for Pete Kosinski as he goes down the front straightaway. Tony Cantalamisa down the back straightaway, so pretty much a big gap here. Cantalamisa, barring any catastrophic events, going to pick up the win in this one, Mike.
Yeah, take a look at Cantalamisa riding very smooth out there. Tony, again, sponsored by Wade Chapin Performance, who is down here in the pits with us this weekend. Great to have Wade down here. Wade has been not only spinning wrenches, but he's been racing for a long, long time, and always a good time to have Wade in the pits. Always got a smile on his face, and if you ever need any advice about your personal watercraft or somebody to turn the wrenches the right way, man, go to Wade Shape and Performance, located in Sarasota.
Picking up that win on the 79 machine, Cantala Mesa, in the moto number one here for Pro-Am Super Stock Ski. Pete Kaczynski working his way through the outside split section, going to wrap it up in a second as we prep for race number four, Pro-Am Runabout Box Stock, Mike. So like you said, run it on Saturday, sell it on Monday.
I'll tell you what, we got a pretty good crowd here in this Pro-Am Runabout Box Stock, and just taking a look down, there is nobody who stands out like is going to be like an obvious winner here. But you know, one of the things that I am looking at here, that there's no Kawasaki's represented. And I seen Eric Francis down there in the pits earlier today. So I'm wondering why Francis ain't in this box stock class. Oh, he is? He's just not on the list. Okay, he is, but he's not on the list. Okay, so we'll have to write him in.
Yeah, well, we know his boat number should be 911, right?
I believe so. I see Mr. Francis down there, though. How you doing, Mr. Francis? Good to see you, Ed. Down there from Dave's Auto Body, located in West Palm Beach, Florida. Dave's Auto Body's actually helped us out before, you know. I mean, they're always helping out. And when you see Ed Francis on the beach, he's one of the hardest working dads on the beach, man. This guy is always running back and forth, to and fro. Anything that his boy needs or his team needs, he is on it. Great to have him in the pits with us as well.
Well, I remember back in the day, Mike, we'd come down for your races down here in the, like we used to come down for that Macon race all the time. And that was back when Eric Francis was just a little knicker.
Yeah, he used to be, and he's grown up since.
Well, we're loading the lineup for this one, Pro-Am Runabout Box Stock, race number four. Let's. You ready to do the lineup there, Mike? You ready to work our way through this one?
37. Yeah, Eric's going to be on boat number 37, so we could say boat number 37, sponsored by Monster Energy, Kawasaki, and Dave's Auto Body, is the Eagle, Eric Francis.
Also down online at a Rydell, Georgia, run for Metal Roofing, MFG, Dean's Team, and Riva. On the number eight machine, Jeff Dykowski.
Out of Bradenton, Florida, riding for Judge Motorsports, Jet Pilot, and Riva. Boat number 110, the Slugger, Troy Snyder.
Out of Bellevue, Florida, riding for Hidden Trails Motorsports, C2X Team, and Jet Trim. On the 149, Tim Duquette.
Boat number 153, out of Abbeville, Alabama, Anthony Redditch.
Out of Clermont, Florida, riding for Fly Racing, Jet Lift, Riva, Black Tip, Sea-Doo, and Aztec Racing, 247, Dylan Osborne.
And from Bel Air Bluffs, Florida, riding the top of Sea-Doo, sponsored by Black Tip Jet Sports, Sea-Doo, and the Sea-Doo X Team, and Riva, 404, is Brent Venderly. And that rounds out your field, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, it's a good thing that we had Eric Francis join there, because like you had pointed out, we didn't have any Kawis down there. We obviously know that Eric Francis is a Kawasaki factory pilot, so he's down there representing Kawi in this one now.
So it looks like all the manufacturers are represented in this Pro-Am Runabout Box Stock. And now if a Sea-Doo would win, Sea-Doo X Team, I believe, would pay some bounty on this because it's over a certain number of riders.
Yeah, the other thing, too, is that Jet Lift, there's Jet Lift contingency money this weekend while we're here, too. So if the rider has Jet Lift stickers on both sides of the machine representing Jet Lift, they'll pay contingency money as well.
Yeah, one of the things that you want to remember that if you don't have those stickers on, you probably want to put them on before you get out there and race this weekend because they are checking them. Randy Jugworth down there at Tech is checking to make sure that you have the proper credentials in order to win some of that contingency money, folks. All right, Pro-Am Runabout Box Stock. All right, crowd starting to pick up here at Sugden Regional Park. I'd like to say a very special thanks to Mike, who runs the ski team and pretty much runs the Lake Avalon here at Sugden Regional Park. And he has been running tirelessly for us as we've been here for the last 8 days. And we started off last Friday with Frankie Zapata, Zapata Racing, and the Flyboard World Cup Championships. That was followed on Monday by the Pro Watercross Hydro Drag World Championships presented by HydroTurf. And of course, continuing on Wednesday, and we've had, this is our fourth day in a row, Pro Watercross racing. Great to be here.
Well, Mike, this just came down from Nick Handler, the flagman down there on the tower. It looks like it's going to be 10-lapper.
Yeah, I was just trying to fill in some time right there. I was trying to figure out whether we were doing laps or time today. Tomorrow is time. Today is laps.
Wow, that band snapped quick, and we had some hole shots on the inside, hole shots on the outside, trying to figure out who that was. Looks like that, maybe Dykowski on the outside.
Yeah, it looks like Snyder on the inside, and Francis pushes Osborne a little bit wide there on that big wide-body Kawasaki. That is Dykowski on the outside, going to be Slugger on the inside, side by side, and here we go.
Dykowski sweeps around the outside, and he's able to shut the door.
All right, it is time to take the gloves off, baby. It's the World Championships right here in Naples.
So Dykowski came off that outside split section. It really looked like Snyder had a better start and ran a better inside split, but with that momentum heading into that double red at the end of the straightaway, Dykowski pulling the hole shot.
Yeah, you know, it's funny how, you know, people make excuses. Well, this didn't happen, this didn't happen, this didn't happen. You know, it just reminds me of a phrase that my high school football coach used to say, and especially right here, this is what it's all about. Don't give me the labor pains, just show me the baby.
I like that one. So here we go through the split sections. Dykowski now on the number 8 machine, off that split section on the outside. He's going to run it, as is Troy Snyder, and as is Ducat on the 149 bow. Eric Francis chooses to go to the inside to see if he can make up some ground.
Well, Slugger settled in there in that second place position. As you pointed out, Ducat in third, Francis in fourth, Osborne in fifth. And oh, look at this battle down here. Venderly pushes Radetich wide to get into that sixth place. And Radetich, I'll tell you what, a good story there too. Radetich coming close to a world title a little earlier this week. We'll see how that ends up tomorrow, because there was a little controversy on that. However, Radetich is one of our only handicapped riders out there. He's got a special seat that's made that they strap him into. And Mike, I'm sure you remember the first handicapped rider that that came out and raced with us in the Great Lakes. He was from the Great Lakes, Russ Hoy. And he used to race on a an old Wave Raider, if you remember. Those things wouldn't turn on a dime, and they wouldn't even turn on a half dollar.
No, they wouldn't. And every once in a while, they'd hunt and find their own line, too. I remember seeing Russ swim a few times, but man, talk about upper body strength, because he didn't have the use of the waist down.
Well, Tim Ducat now able to move up into second place. Snyder slides back to third, and right behind Snyder is the Eagle, Eric Francis. And the Francis and Snyder have been known to rub rails before, maybe once or twice.
So Dykowski still really gotten away with this one, as he's already around the MasterCard buoy and on the split section. The rest of the riders coming down the back straightaway. But Tim Ducat had made that nice pass now into that second position. That puts Snyder back there in third. And here comes Eric Francis on that 37 machine, coming hard, trying to close that gap, Mike.
Yeah, Dykowski, the eight ball that's working right in front of you right now, your current leader. You know, I talked to him yesterday, already closed one world championship a little bit earlier. He told me, said, Mike, Naples, Florida is the best place I've ever been. He said, I'm having the time of my life down here, and his boat is running great. And he said he has a very big special thanks to Dean Cherrier and Dean's team for helping him out this season.
Yeah, I talked to him this morning too, and he was, you know, pretty proud of his riding capabilities and what he'd accomplished, but he was also the first one to give props where props are due. He said he'd like to thank Dean's team and Riva too for helping to make this thing possible, giving props out to Dean Cherrier.
And that is pretty awesome. Again, you're watching race number 4, a 10-lap race here in the Pro-Am Runabout Box Stock. Coming up next, race number 5, Sport GP. Oh, another sport class. Uh-oh, and it looked like Dykowski got a little sideways there.
Yeah, Dykowski did. He had a couple of slide-outs, and it allowed Ducat to close the gap. So Ducat now hard charging on the 149 boat down the front straightaway, Mike.
Well, Dykowski don't want to slide out too much. Once again, Jeff out of Riddell, Georgia. He's on the Yamaha, 58 years fast. Now, Ducat, who's right behind him, has got 25 years his junior, only 33 years old. So 5 more laps to go. We'll see if Dykowski can hold off that young gun there in Ducat.
Well, interesting enough, too, you got Ducat out there on the Sea-Doo and Dykowski on the Yamaha. So we got the manufacturers competing here as well as the racers, Mike.
Yeah, I'm sure Scott Hollywood Watkins and Tim McKercher, Cody Hawkins, all watching the live stream right now to see who's winning the battle of the manufacturer in this box stock division. And boys, if you are watching, hello, how you doing? And we miss you here in Naples.
So one more time, off that split section, we come off the outside. Dykowski on the 8 machine, still holding on to that lead, but Tim Ducat trying to close that gap. He followed him through that outside split section that time rather than going to the other and avoiding the whitewash.
Well, the green flag is out. Snyder still in that third place position. Hey, folks, while we have the opportunity, I'd like to say a special hello and welcome to Rich and Helen McCluggage. Great to have the McCluggage family here. Rich, I didn't mean to call you Rick yesterday. Hi, Miss Helen. How you doing? We miss you up here from the Tower of Power. Helen down there with her lovely granddaughter, Lily. And you know, some folks down there also in getting the Hard Luck Award. They drove all the way from Washington. Kevin Redinger and Dan Masters. And I seen on Facebook last night where David, his plane was leaking axle grease, and there was no way that he could make it here in time. So them guys came all the way down from Washington, and unfortunately, the rider got stuck back up in Seattle.
Oh, man, that's terrible.
What a tough break. Brutal. All right, well, if you look out there, top right-hand side of the track, Dykowski coming up to a lapper. Things starting to chop up out there. You see a lot of whitewater here within the closed course area. And look at Ducat. Ducat now only about a second and a half off the pace, being thrown down by Dykowski. Is age, does age matter here? I don't know.
I don't know. Age may matter. As they go down that front straightaway, it looks like Dykowski's boat just a tad faster as he stretched that gap out. Now, this will be interesting. Ducat been following Dykowski through the outside split section. Will he do it again? And he does, Mike.
Okay, yeah, he does. Only got a couple more laps if he's going to get him. Again, that middle section just seems to be a little bit more chopped up, and that's why a lot of riders not choosing that inside split, and here they go.
Dykowski went a little bit wide, maybe a little wider than he meant to, but he's trying to carry that momentum. Here comes Ducat, trying to choose a different line, go wide, tuck inside, stay out of that whitewash, and as they go to the double yellow on the chicane, Ducat closing that gap.
Well, I'll tell you one thing about Ducat. The kid is not scared. As you said, he's almost bit his tongue off twice this year in racing, and he is not afraid to stick the nose of that Sea-Doo in there and show Dykowski what his keel looks like. Two more laps, or about a lap and a half left to go for your leaders. And again, what's going on here is Dykowski stretching it out down that back straightaway, and every time they come into a tighter section, that Sea-Doo is cornering a little better than that Yamaha. Mike?
Yeah, I got to believe that's true because that's what's happening. Oh, Dykowski goes to the inside split section this time. We'll see if that comes back to haunt him. There's a lapper on the outside. Ducat to the outside. Dykowski on the inside. Dykowski was trying that inside split a few times yesterday. And, Mike, as they come to the merge, Dykowski on the inside going to have just enough. He's going to try to push Ducat wide.
Oh, white flag is out. This is where champions are made. And there goes Dykowski pushing him to the window, to the wall.
Wow, I tell you what. Dykowski came around there. He cut that inside. Ducat had visions of going wide, tucking inside, but Dykowski whitewashed him like there was no tomorrow.
Right. This isn't Peter Pan. We ain't taking no visions here today. It's time to show me the baby.
Well, that was white flag out, too, so this is the last chance. If Ducat going to make his pass, he's got to make it happen. Now, Eric Francis trying to close that gap as well.
All right. Got a lapped rider in front of Dykowski. Lapped rider goes to the outside. I believe that's Rededich. And Dykowski going to follow suit. Ducat does not go to the inside.
What's going on, Mike? Why did he not run the inside split?
Well, this is a qualifier. That's what's going on. It's just a qualifier. If it was a moto, I think Ducat would have went to the inside. Checkered flag coming out. Folks, put your hands together for Jeff Dykowski holding off the young gun, Tim Ducat.
Dykowski picking up that win. Ducat going to wrap it up in second. Yeah, I wondered why Ducat didn't go to the inside, but just like you said, this is a qualifier, and so it's just for a spot online in that main.
Yeah, it looked like the Eagle, Eric Francis, coming through in third. Snyder in fourth. Osborne in fifth. Venderly in sixth. Rededich will round out your top seven. Mike?
Well, real quick, before we go to the next race, race number five, we've got Shay up here from Jetlift. And Shay, why don't you grab the mic here? Let's do a quick interview. I was talking to some of your folks today, talking about the products that you brought down. You see that I'm obviously sporting the Jetlift hat now. Shay, what's going on down there in your vendor alley, and what can folks expect if they come over to visit you?
Well, actually, right now we're getting ready. We're going to start shooting off some shirts. So we'll be getting a crowd together. So try to find me. I'll be in front of the grandstands, and then we're going to shoot some shirts off. So you can be ready to catch some shirts.
So when you say shoot some shirts off, I'm imagining you have one of those shirt cannons down there with the canister and whatnot.
It's more like a shirt bazooka, but yeah.
So it's a shirt bazooka, and you've got it dialed in. You've practiced with this thing, right? No one's going to, like, you know, lose a melon or anything?
Well, only the person shooting it. No. We did a couple test fires this morning, so, yeah, we're ready to go.
All right, now, you guys came down to, you brought a lot of product with you. The goal, obviously, when you come to an event like this, especially as a presenting sponsor, is to sell as much product as you can. You've got all kinds of sales going on here. Looks like the jet lift hitch hauler down to 385 from 485. Are you gonna take product back with you, or are you gonna try to sell as much as you can while you're here?
So far today, I mean, we've been doing great. Today, we sold a lot of product already. You know, we got some product out sitting out front of our booth and everything. We'd love to get rid of it. So if you guys come over to the booth, some great deals going on right now. And yeah, I mean, if you want Jetlift product, today is gonna be the day to pick it up.
Well, and the thing is, too, when you have Pro Day, you get more fans that show up. You get some fans that come in. A lot of these people are would-be racers at home, and they're realizing when they get here, wow, that's cool. I don't have that. I need that. I want to be like a pro racer. So we're inviting everybody to come on over there and check out the Jetlift tent and set up there in Vendor Alley. And we'll probably do something nice during freestyle today, too, and try to get folks to migrate to your area right at the beginning or end of the freestyle event.
Perfect. Sounds great.
All right. Thanks, Shay. We appreciate you and everything that Jetlift is doing for the tour. I look forward to seeing you shooting that cannon real soon.
All right. Once again, getting ready for this Sport GP class. Man, this has been one of the best classes that we've seen all summer long. Battles in and out all over the United States. On the Hidden Trail Sea-Doo Pro Watercross Tour presented by Jetlift. Here we are at the World Championships. By the way, I'd like to say a special hello to Carrie, who is listening in back home with my little baby Pekka.
You said it, not me.
It ends with an A. Sport GP class, Mike, is coming up next. Let's talk a little bit about these riders.
Yeah, you know, Sport GP, it was one of the best classes that we had as Sport Stock during the qualifiers. We had 17 racers in yesterday's race in the stock class, but now we're looking at GP, which means pretty much anything goes under the hood.
Hey, for those folks that may be listening in at home, this just in, catch this. You know, we got the obviously Sea-Doo, and we got Yamaha down there, but I understand Crash Industries may have a boat that fits within them sport specs that may be able to get out here and race next year.
Thank you for the setup, Mike. I appreciate that. And oddly enough, my friend Craig Behrens just called me from Crash Industries. He's helping out the folks. They're Aussies, and they are producing a machine that could fit within the sport specs here and could be race worthy by next year.
Boy, that would be excellent to add Crash Industries to the Yamaha and Sea-Doo lineup. Obviously, Kawasaki riding the X2. We did have a vintage X2 class a little bit earlier this week. Not too many X2s showing up, but if we could get Crash Industries in here, boy, I'll tell you what, we've got 12, 13 people down there online. We had 17 yesterday in the sport. We could fill up these sport class lines.
But I'll tell you what, Mike, I met the folks from Crash Industries just a week or so ago. They came in from Australia, and they've got a number of machines, four or five different machines they're producing. One of them is very much set up like the Blaster, maybe a little more freestyle oriented, but obviously could be pushed into the sport class, and we're looking forward to having those folks join racing as well as freestyle here in the States.
Boy, that certainly would be awesome. Again, you're watching race number 5, Sport GP. Let's go down to the line. Boat number 08 out of Landrum, South Carolina, riding on a bullet hole, sponsored by Fly Racing, Jet Pilot, Jet Trim, Hot Products, HydroTurf, and I'm sure Mom and Dad. How about it for Devin Walker?
Out of Port St. Lucie, Florida, riding on the Sea-Doo, on number 10, David Gorey.
Boat number 13 from Cooper City, Florida, sponsored by Broward Motorsports, Judge Motorsports, Exotic Signs, Shoei, Jet Pilot, Wambleton's, I Saw, Jetlift, and Thrust Innovations, Sam Neamy.
Out of Naples, Florida, riding for Weight Shape and Performance, Broward Motorsports, Exotic Signs, Wambleton's Customs, on 14, Keith Dill.
And ladies and gentlemen, on boat number 22 from Clearwater, Florida, he is sponsored by Team Faith, Fly Racing, Western Power Sports, Pirelli, KTM, Jetlift, Amsoil, Wiseco, as well as SS decals, M&M Marine, Renegade, Liquid Performance, Fuel, Dragon, Tubeless, Stamens Motorsports, Jet Dynamics, ClearwaterMortgageBroker.com, Industrial Machine, Ross Products, and Pro Watercraft Racing. That is Gage Schoenher.
Out of St. Petersburg, Florida, riding for Jersey Mike Subs on 43, Michael Osborne.
Boat number 77 out of Osteen, Florida, riding for OptimalRacing.com, Glenn Young.
Out of Naples, Florida, riding on the Yamaha for HPE, Amsoil, Scott Goggles 92, Sean Reynolds.
Boat number 111, one for each of his world titles. He's out of Christmas, Florida, riding for the Anderson Clan, TwoStrokePorting.com, Slacker Graphics, and Walker Racing, as well as RTR, Richard Taylor.
Out of Madison's, Mississippi, riding for Judge Motorsports, R&D, Scat Track, Jet Trim, and Jet Pilot on the Yamaha, number one USA, Billy Dearman.
Boat number 346 from Dawsonville, Georgia, riding for IPD Graphics, Riva Racing, and Extreme Throttle, Kyle Hayes.
Out of Naples, Florida, riding on the Sea-Doo for Absolute Performance, Signworks, Amsoil, and Extreme Throttle, 367, Robert Saya.
And finally, boat number 375 out of Bel Air Beach, Florida, riding for Bad Boys Racing, the Stay and Play Marina Resort, and Coastal Culture, that's Robert Cias. And Robert, formerly one of the owners of the Hot Water Tour that used to be produced down here in Florida for many, many years, along with his partner, Pete Kaczynski, who is racing a little earlier today.
Yeah, I remember the Hot Water Tour. That was some hot racing back in the day. Speaking of hot racing, we're down here in Naples, Florida for the Pro Watercross World Championships, and we're starting this one up, Mike.
Oh, yeah. Sport GP race number 5. It is time to kick the tires and light the fires.
Well, no, it's going to be a no-go, Mike.
Yeah.
We had a boat machine that wasn't ready here on the end. That's going to be a red flag start. We're going to pull them back. And how do you say that? Your repack thing?
Yeah, we're going to come back to the line, repack, restack, re-rack, and restart this one all over again. And you can see Sam Neamey's boat got a piece of that rubber band. And you had our second rider in here that was actually calling for a 2-minute hold, and there was none. A lot of band snapped as he was going to give him the 2-minute hold, so they're going to bring him back with a complete setup and a regate, a complete restart here.
Yeah, we had that, Nick Handler was looking down the line, and we had that second rider right up here. He set such a full gate of racing. I don't think he quite saw it, but the course marshals did, trying to get that 2-minute hold. Eventually, that boat did run, and it left the line, so hopefully we can come back and get a good clean start this time.
Fantastic. Again, folks, you're watching race number 5, and don't forget to stop down there and say hello to Rita, who is at the Pro Watercross World Championships merchandise booth just on the right-hand side of our camera tower on the north side of the stage. You could pick up your Jetlift 2-wheel Lowboy. Retails for $1,350. World Championship special, only $1,000. Again, that is down at Jetlift. And, of course, don't forget to stop at the Pro Watercross merchandise booth right beside it.
Well, I kind of thought that we might have a re-rack here because that's a lot of boats, that's a lot of holders, all going off to you here in the Sport GP, and we're going to re-rack these guys as they fix the band there.
And you can see the stands and the beach starting to fill up here at Sugden Regional Park, and again, we'd like to say a very special thanks to all the officials who have made our stay really red carpet worthy. And a special thanks to the Naples Beach Hotel, our host hotel. Man, what a place that is, huh, Mike?
Yeah, it's real nice. I'm looking forward to maybe lounging by the pool a little bit later this afternoon. Now, this race number 5, Sport GP here, this is a qualifier. So, again, these guys are racing for position to be set up in tomorrow's main event that is going to air on CBS Sports.
All right. So, again, as Mike pointed out, we are racing for position. I believe this one also going to be 10 laps. And it looked like Bill Dearman getting a great jump on the inside.
Yeah, Dearman with a jump on the inside. Mike Neamey's boat, one of the top competitors here, Sam Neamey on the 13 machine. His machine did not leave the line on the outside.
Well, Rich Taylor just pushes Dearman out of the way there on that inside split. Dearman slides back to a second. Dylan third on the inside. That's Glenn Young on the outside. And here we go. I believe that's Young followed by Gorey, and it's going to be Rich Taylor. Glenn Young coming on hard on the outside. Boat number 10, Gorey settles in third. Keith Dill, 14, in the fourth spot. And in the fifth spot, I believe, that was the double deuce of Gage Schoenher. So that's how they stack up 1 through 5 here on lap number one. And Don Anderson, them guys are pumped up, man. You know, Rich Taylor, the guy out in front, was the one that kept saying sport class to you. How many people in the sport class? That's why he was doing that. And Rich Taylor looking for his next world title. And look at this. Him and Young down the back straightaway. And I'll tell you what, Young, he was out here testing his boat yesterday. That thing sounded like a beast. And for Taylor to do what he's doing, sponsored by the Anderson clan, that is something special.
Yeah, we talked to him earlier, as well as Susan Anderson, about the machines and about the sport class and about the coverage. Again, one of the top classes today, Sport GP, and Richard Taylor out of Christmas, Florida, is just lighting it up down the front straightaway. 77, Glenn Jung in second, and that 10 machine, David Gorey, in third.
I'll tell you what, you know, I got to say, I really like Dave Gorey's theory here. He comes out, he doesn't have no paint job, he's got like stock numbers, you know, and that's what I call sleeper to the finest right there.
Dave Gorey. Well, here's part of the story too, is Sam Neamey, who's been lighting it up all year long on the tour in the sport class, his machine did not leave the line. Now, he's one of the fastest guys that we've seen in Sport GP. His machine did not leave the line. He's got a lot of work to do to cut through the pack.
Well, I'll tell you what, Mike, he's already done a lot of work. Sam has already worked his way back up into that sixth place position. You can see him going down the back straightaway right now. Obviously, probably not going to get a top qualifier spot, but to be somewhere near the front, I think that's where you're going to see him, one of the top three spots, on whether it be the inside or outside split. We shall see.
Well, that's one of the benefits of being in a qualifier. So in a qualifier, it's unlike a moto stat. So the qualifier is just working you to get that spot online. So we're going to see where those guys fare tomorrow. And Neamey going to get another shot.
One thing I did notice here, Young able to maintain his position, Neamey able to maintain his position. But just went out and he picked up the penalty buoy over there on the far south side of the track here.
Well, back to the front of the pack as they go down that back straightaway. Richard Taylor out of Christmas, Florida, riding it up for the Anderson clan, twostrokeboarding.com, Slacker Graphics, and Walker Racing, as well as RTR. He's a man on a mission as he comes off that MasterCard buoy to the outside split section.
Rich Taylor, your leader, working his way through the outside split. Glenn Young and Dave Gorey, Keith Dill, all following suit, all going to that outside, that inside, man. I'll tell you what, when things get motored around here, it really chops up, and that's got a lot of people scared.
Well, you know, it's pretty choppy here. It's very much like arena cross here at Sugden Park in Naples, Florida. And the water's getting choppy, but at some point in time, Mike, someone's going to have to take that inside split and try it.
You know, one of the things that I think that has to come into play here, when you're a racer and you're out there qualifying and you're in one of the top two positions, even if you're in that second place position, you know that you're going to have the pole, whether it's going to be the inside or the outside. So a two is really just as good as a one here in qualifying.
True that, Mike. That is so true. In the qualifier, a twos is good. You'll have the pole if you want it. Now, we watched it earlier when they had qualifiers, and riders were able to select their position based on their finish earlier. We'll wonder if they'll do that tomorrow in the mains.
Well, I believe that that is pretty much protocol, Mike. And here comes the flag that you don't want to see. There's a blue flag with a yellow stripe on it, and that means there's a race going on, and you ain't in it.
Well, the front of the pack moving up on the back of the pack as Richard Taylor down the front straightaway, closing up on that back of the pack. Courtesy flags out, Mike, halfway through this one.
Wow, and I'll tell you, Glenn Young really riding on the edge of the envelope there. Look at Schoenhauer trying to keep off the mad pace that Neamey's putting up, and Schoenhauer gets stuffed over there in that corner again. Gage Schoenhauer is a top quality rider, and he's proved that all season long on the Hidden Trail Sea-Doo Pro Watercross Tour presented by Jetlift. This time, Gage has actually taken Kelly Smith's place. Kelly Smith had rode the tour on that boat, and that's why I told you to hold up when we were announcing him, because they actually have different sponsors for their GP boat than they do their stock boat. So,
well, that's what's nice about working with you, Mike. You knew that. You flipped open your phone, and you made it happen. So rat-a-tat-tat, just like that, you were on top of things.
Which we try to stay on top of it as much as we can, Remar. You know how it is up here. Sometimes it gets a little bit hectic. But we try to make it happen, Captain. And tell you who's making it happen right now is Rich Taylor. Rich Taylor, again, riding for the Anderson clan, as well as twostrokeboarding.com, Slacker Graphics, Walker Racing, and Rich Taylor Racing.
Well, and then you have Keith Dill. Keith Dill is out there on that 14 machine. He's currently holding on to that fourth position.
Yeah, Keith and Sam Neamy, they bumped rails all season long, vying for that top spot on the Pro Watercross National Tour. And Neamy, not used to being behind Dill. Dill used to one being the one that's initiating that contact. We'll see if Sam Neamy does the same thing to Dill as they head down the back straightaway. Dave Gorey still in the third place position. And it looks like your leader, Taylor, and Glenn Young, who is in second, have a lapped rider in between them.
Well, Taylor was coming up on a lapped rider, but that lapped rider had to actually go pick up the penalty buoy. So that allowed Taylor to get by him with no problems whatsoever. But then that lapped rider came back in between your second place competitor right now, 77, Glenn Jung. So Jung on the 77 boat being followed by Gorey on 10. And then 14, Keith Dill, and then Sam Neamy on that 13 machine. Those top four, five, six riders really looking good, Mike, but Taylor still has a pretty commanding lead.
Yeah, you can see Taylor lighting it up down the back straightaway right now, and he has pretty much got just about a full back straightaway lead over second place, Glenn Young, who is now making the turn, heading onto the back straightaway as Rich hits that MasterCard buoy, and he'll opt for the outside split. Now two lapped riders in between Rich Taylor and Glenn Young, and Taylor trying to make a snoozer out of this one.
Well, I'll tell you what, Taylor, yesterday, he was really proud of the sport class. He kept saying, what class is this? What class is this? He's obviously here to represent today. What class is this?
Yeah, two more laps to go for Taylor on the Triple Aces. By the way, we'd like to say a very special thanks to everyone who is listening in on the Visit West Virginia live stream. My name is Mike Young. We got Mike Remar hanging out with me. And, Mike, it has been a fantastic week so far. Oh, Keith Dill now able to get past Dave Gorey, as is Sam Neamy. So Dill moves up into third, Neamy into fourth, Gorey slides back to fifth.
Wow, just like that. I tell you what, Dill and Neamy, just like you said, they've been going at it and swapping all year long on the tour. Both of them made the pass on Gorey at the same time.
Meanwhile, tough break there for Devin Walker, who comes off over there, top right-hand side of the track. Course marshals over to assist. And a big shout-out to our course marshals, Icy Mike Root, and, of course, Drake Lewis, and Randy Scott. Yellow flags are out over in that section, but not going to affect our leader, I don't think, as the white flag gets ready to come out. Remar?
White flag out for Richard Taylor. He's down the front straightaway, like you said, making a snoozer out of this one. But the real race for second place over here on the top left-hand canter. Of course, a rider down, and here comes your second place competitor, Glenn Young, on the 77 with Dill following, then Gorey, then Neamy.
Oh, it looked like a Glenn. Glenn, it sounded like Glenn Young's boat just shut off right here in front of the Tower of Power and refired. Mike, you're a former racer. What's going through your mind when that happens?
You know, you just try not to lose your mind. Your heartbeat's going. The adrenaline's pumping through you. You're like, oh, my gosh, oh, my gosh, oh, my gosh. But you stay smooth, calm, collected, get it fired back up, and begin racing.
Yeah, I was thinking dirty wetsuit, but we'll go back out to Rich Taylor, who hits the MasterCard buoy. That's where they make the turn to go into the split. That is the green and red tied up, top left-hand side of the track. Taylor through the splits one last time. And Mike Remar, Taylor has looked pretty much flawless out here in the qualifier.
Yeah, he ran that great hole shot. He ran such an incredible split. Now he's picking up the penalty buoy, maybe just for insurance. I didn't see him miss one, but he's so far ahead.
Oh, yeah. And how about it, folks? Put your hands together. He is sponsored by the Anderson clan, Rich Taylor, and he does the old dap coming across the finish line.
Wrapping it up in second place, then going to be 77, Glenn Young. And then 14, Keith Dill, going to wrap it up in third with Gorey in fourth on the 10 machine.
Yeah, I'll tell you, and Gage Schoenherr rounding out your top five here in the Sport GP. Once again, this was only a qualifier. I cannot wait for that main event. It's going to be shown on CBS Sports tomorrow.
The real thing there was we watched Dill and Neamy going at it when they made the pass on Gorey a couple of laps ago. What happened to Neamy that last lap?
Not quite sure. You can see Sam working his way into the split section. We'll have to go back to the video rewind for that. They probably got it on the live stream. Unfortunately, there was so much action, we didn't get it up here.
Action Jackson, I tell you what, that was an incredible race. Again, much like yesterday, the sport class providing some serious action and some great racing here in Naples, Florida for the Pro Watercross World Championships.
Is that six? All right, race number six, Pro-Am Ski Super Stock, Moto number two. We need you to the starting line. Pete Kosinski and Tony Candelamesa, we need you to the starting line. Once again, one of our smaller races. They're going to go ahead and run two motos of that today and get that out of the way so it ain't a part of tomorrow's program. Uh-oh. Shay, what's up? Uh-oh. Does Brian have the T-shirt cannon down there? Brian Versoke, the birthday boy, got the T-shirt cannon. Look out, ladies and gentlemen. T-shirts coming from heaven.
Oh, yeah, first one goes high in the sky. Talk about accuracy.
It's coming right into the stands, right behind the stands over here. I'll tell you, you know, they used to let me loose with one of those. For those of you folks in the stands, look for the T-shirt cannon right down here to the right. Brian Versoke has got the cannon loaded up. Look out, Mike. He's got the big guns.
Yeah, well, you know, Cantalamisa's over there. I actually think he's supposed to be getting ready for his race, but they're down there. Can you get one to go that far? Cantalamisa wants a T-shirt.
Hey, you know, I know that he can get one to go that far. I used to run one on the National Arena Cross Series, and let me tell you something. I used to hit people in the third row. I mean, I could take beers out of people's hands from about 100 feet away, at least. Here we go. Brian Versoke with the Jet Lift T-shirt cannon. Shoot it right from the Jet Lift. Are you guys racing again, Tony?
Yeah, I don't think they do.
Yeah, this is moto number two for you guys. You and Pete, moto number two for you guys. This is race number six, guys. Race number six in the T-shirt cannon. Getting loaded back up. Who wants a free T-shirt? I said, who wants a free T-shirt out there? Come on, make some noise. All right. Well, Brian, why don't you try to hit, like, right here in front of the stage? Why don't you shoot it up, try to get it right here in front of the stage? We'll have everybody gather right here. Once again, don't knock your neighbor down. This is a polite T-shirt cannon competition here. Did everybody sign a waiver?
Yeah, I think they did sign a waiver. You got to have a wristband on to be able to catch one.
So, Larry, are you ready for all this craziness?
Oh, yeah, it's just beginning.
Just beginning. Pretty exciting to have you out here and be our keynote speaker here, as well as represent us on CBS Sports.
You know, I'm looking forward to it. It's been quite a while since I've been in front of the camera where you can actually see me. And hopefully I'll add a little something to the event, and I'm loving it here already.
Well, let me tell you something, my friend. You already have added a lot to the event. You know, you're probably one of the most respected, if not the most respected, personal watercraft player ever.
Why? Thank you.
No, I mean, you know, when it comes to old school folks, man, that it actually got to where the pioneers in the sport, you know, I think of you, I think of Silverstein, I think of Strickland, I think of Bendix, those names there.
Yeah, you know, when I first got into the sport, it was the Silversteins, the Stricklands that were my heroes coming in. So it was a dream come true to continue to move up the ladder. And here we go. Here comes another T-shirt.
All right, folks, get ready. The T-shirt cannon is getting ready to be set, and here we go. There we go. Oh, goes a little bit short. Oh, look at that. Interception. Oh. Hey, by the way, Tampa Bay is looking for a defensive back.
Wow. Oh, and he gave it up like the polite gentleman. He gave it to the little girl.
There you go. You got to be polite. Give it up to the little. How many you got? You got five more? 5 minutes. 5 minutes to the next shot. All right, we're going to get Tony the Tornado and Pete Kosinski up here. Race number six, Mike, we have talked about him. In that first race, it was the Tornado taking the win in moto number one.
Yeah, he got that killer hole shot. They came down the front straightaway, and Kosinski and Tony Tornado got into it over here on the right side. But then after that, Cantalamisa just kind of ran away with it. It wasn't the most exciting race in the world, but we'll see if Kosinski can fix it up, and we'll make for a more exciting one in moto two.
Yeah, Tornado was over here. He was trying to get himself a T-shirt. Didn't know his moto was up. All right. How we doing, Lewis Malone? Good to see you down there. Robert Cias, time to stay and play, huh? Great to have all the families and friends, sponsors, riders come out and be a part of the Hidden Trails Sea-Doo Pro Watercross Tour presented by Jet Lift. Hey, by the way, folks, don't forget to stop down at Abaco Sunglasses. They're located right in front of Camera Tower 1. Just on the north side of the announcing tower. They've got the two-for-one special down there today. For $30, you can get two sets of sunglasses, not just one, but two sets. And guess what, folks? They are polarized. Normally, these sunglasses sell for $35 a pair. today, 2 for 1, but he's going to drop 5 more off the price, so only $30, and that is from Abaco Sunglasses, and we are glad to have him here. Also down there, if you'd like to sample some Shark Energy drink, tell you what, want to put a little pep in your step? Mike, I know sometimes we need pep in our step, but when we do need that, we're definitely we're fed intravenously with Shark Energy drink.
Well, you know what's cool about it too is it tastes really, really good. You know, there's some of those energy drinks out there that they say they do this, they say they do that, and then you take a swig of it and you're like, ah, no, I don't like it. Shark tastes really, really good.
Hey, Mike, there has been a Pikachu spotting here in front of the stage. There's a Pikachu spotting in front of the stage here. You ever see them guys walking around with their phone looking for Pokemon?
Yeah, I've seen that.
I don't get it. I still don't get it. What do you get if you get the most Pokemon? I mean, like, did you get an award or is there like,
I don't know, did you get a free TV dinner? I was talking to my son about it and he's like, yeah, we're going to cure American obesity with this game because it actually gets you up off your couch and walking around to catch these Pokemon and see some interesting things while you're out and about.
Well, you know, when I was a kid, we just played ball.
Right.
I mean, I don't know. We weren't looking for fake Pokemon. All right, folks, looks like we've got our riders lined up, and it is going to be Tony the Tornado from the inside, and it'll be Pete Kaczynski on the outside.
Well, and this is race number 6, Pro-Am Ski Superstock, so let's get our next race dominant on the line, Pro-Am Ski GP. Pro-Am Ski GP, along with Pro-Am Women's Ski Limited, race number 7 should be reporting to the line, Mike.
Yeah, it looks like we're going to get through eight with AB. That's actually 9 races. We should get through all of them before we go to our amateur freestyle second moto. I think pro freestyle's first moto is today.
I believe that's correct, Mike. Let's go back to the racing action as these two riders come off the split sections.
And it looks like it is going to be the Tornado coming from the inside. Kaczynski on the outside. Riding for Jack's Marina and PWC Rentals, located up there just on the north side of Treasure Island.
What do you need? Gotcha.
All right, who out there needs some cortisone 10, maximum strength? I don't know, did somebody lose it? Cortisone 10? I know, we just got it turned in up here at the tower. I thought
of, I got a bunch of bites.
You got a bunch of bites? Hey, oh, that's for bites. Okay, that's what it's for.
Oh, they brought it for Rick.
Right, Zika Rick. All right, once again, Tony the Tornado on the inside, Kaczynski on the outside. By the way, I'd like to say a very special thanks to our great friends from Jet Renew. They've got the C1 all-in-one, which enhances color, protects the finish, spray-on, wipe-off, non-toxic, and biodegradable. I know I need that for my Sea-Doos and Yamahas and Kawasaki's at my house. I know I've got one of each now.
Yeah, we've got a number of machines at my place, too. We've got a whole bunch of machines, so I could definitely be using some of that product as well to make them look good and make that stank go away.
Yeah, speaking of stank away, we do got the stank away also from Jet Renew. By the way, I'd like to say a very special thanks to our title sponsor, Hidden Trails, as well as Sea-Doo and our presenting sponsor, Jet Lift, which is the official tote. Special thanks to Shark Energy, Jet Trim, Solus, HydroTurf, Jet Renew, Wadcon, Bomber Eyewear, and Squatch by Jack Links. And if there's anybody out there that would like some Squatch, feel free to come up here in front of the announcing tower. We've got free squash from the announcing tower. Great little snack here before you stop back at Johnsonville Marketplace and pick up yourself a brat after freestyle today.
How about it, ladies and gentlemen? Who wants some squash? We're passing out free stuff up here at the Tower of Power. I think the Batchelder kids probably need some squash.
Look at this. Pete Kaczynski taking the lead away from Tony the Tornado coming from that outside split.
Well, and it looks like right there, Tony Tornado, I'd have to say he slid on the inside of that yellow buoy. I think he missed that second yellow buoy right there over on the right side chicane. So we'll see if he realizes that happened and picks up the penalty buoy, the equalizer here on this next lap, Mike. But
it'll make it interesting for the third moto if he did and things stay as they are, because that would give Tony a win, that'd give Pete a win. So that means it would all come down to tomorrow. And these two buddies could duke it out for the world title.
Naples. They come down that back straightaway. They get to that MasterCard buoy. Kaczynski going to go to the outside split section. Let's see what Tony Tornado does. He's going to follow him to the outside. But again, I think he missed that second yellow buoy over there. We'll see if he realizes it and picks up the penalty.
Well, I'll tell you what. You've got to go to the outside to pick up the penalty. So either way, he's probably going to follow him to the outside. Yeah, and he's going to go pick up the penalty right now. And that's going to give Kaczynski a great advantage there. And actually, that was a checkered flag lap, so that's a huge advantage.
Yeah, huge advantage, because he did get the win in moto number two. And like we said, they'll go to moto number three then to see what happens.
All right, congratulations, Pete Kaczynski taking the win. Moto number two, which means we need race number seven down on line. Pro-Am Ski GP, Pro-Am Women's Ski Limited. Race number seven, Pro-Am Ski GP, where you at? You should be in the gate. Pro-Am Ski GP, Pro-Am Women's Limited. Pro-Am Ski GP, Pro-Am Women's Limited. We need you down to the starting line. And uh-oh, Jet Lift is set back up. Here we go, another T-shirt giveaway. If you want to gather right down here to the right-hand side of the stage, another T-shirt giveaway, and Brian Versoak, proud of that T-shirt cannon, man, and I love them T-shirt cannons. Those things are a lot of fun. And here we go. You guys ready? In 3, 2, 1. Oh, this one's going deep. Other set of stands. Oh, right behind the stands. Oh, and little Zimmerman says, I got this one. Little Johnny Zimmerman. So, Pro-Am Ski GP and Pro-Am Women's Limited is coming up next, and we are stuffing more T-shirts.
Yeah, they're on the way. They're coming out. That's GP and Women's Limited.
All right, we are loaded up. Fire in the hole. There it is. Oh, right down the center. Who is it going to be? Oh, Hayden Skellen with the hole shot.
He outraced Rita. She didn't get there in time. You got smoked by a little guy.
Oh, next time she's going to give the little guy an elbow to the head, she said. All right, we're loading them back up while we're waiting on our Ski GP class to get down here. We are shooting T-shirts. It's the Jet Lift T-shirt cannon. Remember to support those who support the sport, folks. And nobody doesn't like Jet Lift. Don't forget, they got the Jet Lift two-wheel beach tote. Retail is $785. You can pick it up today for only $625. Also, the Jet Lift scissor sands, normally $185. Stop on down to the Jet Lift booth, as they've got the World Championship special, only $150. Hey, by the way, Chanel Krause, are you here with us today? Chanel Krause, if you are Chanel Krause, wave your hand. Wave your hand if you are Chanel Krause. We need Chanel Krause at the stage. Chanel, you lost something, and we found it. Chanel Krause, if you can hear us, please work your way up here to the stage. Chanel Krause. Once again, Pro-Am Ski GP is coming up next, combined with the Pro-Am Women's Ski Limited. I'd like to say a very special thanks to all of you folks for listening on the 247.com live stream. My name's Mike Young. I'm with Mike Remar. Remar is making sure everybody's all squatched out. And we're just about ready to go here with the lineup. But again, we need Chanel Krause. Chanel Krause, please report to announcing. You left something with one of our vendors. Thank you. All right, Mike. Again, the first time that we've had a chance to take a look at the Pro-Am Ski GP and the Pro-Am Women's Ski Limited.
Yeah, it's race number seven, so they're going to combine the Pro-Am Ski GP along with the Pro-Am Women's Ski Limited. So Sophie Perrin going to get a chance with the Pro-Am Ski GPs. Not quite as much horsepower under that hood, but I expect big things.
Okay, now here's the deal, though. Pro-Am Ski GP, they're qualifying. Pro-Am Women's Ski Limited, moto number one.
Gotcha. Nice pickup there, Mike.
All right, folks. Yeah.
and out of Naples, Florida, run for Monster Energy, Mack Racing, Broward Motorsports, K1, Jet Trim, Jet Pilot, Jet Lift, ADA, and Liquid Militia. Chris McCluggage on the 30.
Great to see Chris racing back in Naples. Vote number 51 from Miramar, Florida, riding for Broward Motorsports, Team Mean Racing, Wet Sport Racing, Exotic Signs, and Wambleton's. That is Speedy David Cabrera.
And out of Apex, North Carolina, riding on the Hurricane Performance, Amsoil, Advent, Ignitions, Imagination, Fabrication, 106, Machine, Bill Hegg.
And from West Palm Beach, Florida, by way of Europe, boat number 296, sponsored by Eric Francis, Sophie Perrin. Sophie Perrin, how you doing, Sophie?
And out of Fowey Branch, Georgia, riding for Optima, Riva, Blosion, IPD, Jet Pilot, Trinity, 100%, and Judge Motorsports on 913, Jordan Carroll.
And that is going to do it, ladies and gentlemen. Race number 7, Pro-Am Ski GP, down online. And just taking a look down there, it looks like Jordan Carroll will be starting from the inside pole, Derek Helm from the outside pole, McCluggage right next to Jordan Carroll on that inside. And here we go, it's Pro-Am Ski GP time here from Naples, Florida.
Well, you know, Mike, I didn't see it on our list here, but it looks like 94 Josh Block. Is that Josh Block that pulled the hole shot on the 94 machine? I see his dad down here holding in the water.
Yeah, that's definitely Josh Block. And Block came on really good toward the end of the Hidden Trail Sea-Doo Pro Watercross Tour, followed by boat number 106, Bill Hegg, rounding out your top five there on lap number one.
So Block got that hole shot off the inside, and McCluggage was following. So as they go through the right side chicane, like you said, Josh Block really started to come on toward the end of this year on the regular tour. I know he picked up one of his first Pro Tour wins this year just a few weeks ago.
All right, yeah, when we were in Lake Hartwell, Georgia. Okay, I believe that was round number five of the Hidden Trails Pro Watercross Tour. And here we go, Josh Block going to go to that inside split.
So Block going to run the split, and there goes McCluggage going to follow, as well as Derek Helm going to chase. Your top four riders all work in the same split. Finally, we've got someone going to run the inside.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, and Bill Hegg going to find much cleaner water there on the inside, as we can see it actually up here from the announcing tower. Water looking really rough on that outside split. Josh Block around the bubble over there by the pier, and still with McCluggage right there keeping him in his gun sights.
Well, Bill Hegg decided to run that inside split on the 106 boat. He actually picked up a position while he did that. So Bill Hegg now moves into that fourth position, trying to chase down 24 Derek Helm, who's trying to chase down McCluggage, who's in second, who's trying to chase down Block out in front.
And there they go, down the back straightaway. And Josh Block right now with a 2.5-second advantage over McCluggage. But McCluggage is closing quick as they work their way around the MasterCard buoy. Again, both Block and McCluggage will opt to go to that outside. And Mike, take a look at the water on the inside. Looks a lot cleaner on the inside right now.
It sure does, but those top three riders all going outside. Now, Hegg going to try it again. Hegg picked up a spot last lap as he went to that inside split. Let's see if he can do it again as he sets his sights on 24, Derek Helm.
Hegg, a very smart rider and a veteran of the sport, and he is right there hot on Derek Helm's heels as he works his way down the front straightaway. And that means Jordan Carroll has slid back into that sixth place position with Cabrera rounding out your top seven here.
Well, Sophie Perrin came out of this one. She's down here behind the start-finish line, and she's got her mechanic with the hood open on that machine. Now, Sophie's actually running Pro-Am Ski GP and Women's Ski Limited at the same time.
Yeah, exactly, and I believe she's actually on some OPP out there. That is Taylor Skellett's boat, who took a second in the 10 to 12-year-old class a little earlier today, and she's out there racing that boat against these GP boats.
Back to the front of the pack as they're working their way on the top left side of the course. McCluggage has really closed that gap on Block.
And it looks like Block goes down, McCluggage goes by. And Chris McCluggage from Naples, Florida. You know, he was in Naples. He moved out to Havasu for a little while, got married, had a couple kids. Now he's back in Naples with his entire family, brother Rick, mom and dad, Rich and Helen. And I'll tell you what, Florida sure is glad to claim Chris back again.
Yeah, I bet they are, and he is currently leading this one. Now, I was talking to Josh Block, and he's been having some ride plate issues. He's trying out some custom ride plates, some things that he and his dad have been working on, and they've been having a hard time with the carbon fiber in the ride plate. melding away, and he's actually put a few holes on him. I'm wondering if that's what happened there.
Well, I'll tell you, one of the things, he's lucky to have got up and just maintained second position, because Derek Helm was right there too. And watch Helm. Helm will take advantage of that if he gets the opportunity. Once again, Derek Helm out of Liberty Lake, Washington, sponsored by Steve Webster and Company at Commander Industries.
Courtesy flags out for this one as McCluggage comes down the front straightaway. Your current leader on the number 30 machine. Now, Block got company as Derek Helm right there knocking on his door. And here comes Bill Hegg off the inside split.
Oh, yeah, it's going to be it. Things are tightening up there for that third place position. And Carroll still in the fifth place position on 9-13. Again, Carroll out of Flowery Branch, Georgia. And rode the whole tour with us. Rides for Optima, Riva, Blosion, IPD Graphics, Jet Pilot, Trinity, 100% Goggles, and Judge Motorsports. Again, for all of you folks just arriving, we'd like to welcome everybody out. You're watching the Hidden Trails Sea-Doo Pro Watercross World Championships, presented by Jetlift.
Well, I tell you, Mike, now that McCluggage got by Block, he is just checking out of this one as he's working his way through that outside split section and really stretching out that lead.
We need race number 8. Please report to the starting line. That's the Pro-Am Runabout GP. Pro-Am Runabout GP, please report to the starting line.
It looks like after race number 8, Mike, we go into the freestyle, because race number 9 and 10, I do believe, are the freestyle, amateur freestyle, and then the pro freestyle as well, coming at us, I think, around 12:30 today, right?
That's what's going on then. Hey, as far as tonight, don't forget the racer party starting at 7 o'clock over at the Parrot Grill and Bar. Tomorrow night for the awards, sit-down banquet over at the Naples Beach Hotel. We've already have over more than 160 reservations. If you, too, would like a reservation for that banquet, please stop and see Jennifer at registration, who is in the hut over there with the green top. And then Larry Rippenkroger will be our guest, our keynote speaker there tomorrow, which is, I think, pretty awesome, man. I can't wait to hear what he has to say.
Yeah, I was talking to A.J. Handler, the promoter of Pro Watercross, about that, and he was pretty geeked about having Rippenkroger on as the guest speaker.
Yeah, I was just going to say, man, look at Derek Helm. Helm is on the move, able to get past Josh Block, and Derek Helm has moved up into second place.
Well, Block missed a buoy, so he had to go pick up the equalizer, which is also going to put Bill Hegg now into that third position.
Oh, and the future brother-in-laws are doing battle right here. As you know, Jordan Carroll and Allie Block got engaged just a couple of months ago, so the brother-in-laws doing a little battle out there, rubbing rails. I like it.
Yeah, I had heard that they got engaged. I thought to myself, oh, my gosh, I'm getting old. I remember when she used to sell cookies at her little cookie stand at the races when she was a little girl.
Oh, yeah. Give me a box of them Thin Mints. I'm good to go. And the Mac Attack in the attack position as he gets ready to come down the front straightaway. And I'm sure making his family and friends proud, all hanging out the locals from right here in Naples. Got all their friends and family here. Speaking of locals in Naples, man, there's one local team here that I would like to say a very special thanks to, and that is Mama Mia's Pizza, you know, the Iantosca clan. These guys do so much for us every time that we come down here to Naples and been on tour with us for years and years. I've actually watched the Iantosca, you know, family grow up with Christina and Arminio and Joey. And they do so much for our sport. And I just want to say thanks from the bottom of our hearts and from all of us to Pro Watercross Tour.
Yeah, and they fed us a couple of times this week, too, the crew. I mean, you and I stopped by the other night and had a pizza. That sauce, I don't know what the special ingredient is, but that sauce was amazing.
I'm telling you, it's all about that cheese, about that cheese. No sauce.
So last time they came through, Nick Handler had shown the two laps to go. McCluggage is going to pick up the white flag this time with just one lap to go, as he has a commanding lead over Derek Helm on the 24 machine, still back in the split. But here comes Bill Hegg. Bill Hegg trying to close that gap on Helm, and then the 913 of Jordan Carroll out there as well. He's going to try that inside split, Mike.
Yeah, Carroll's going to try to find some clean water. We've seen a couple riders make that inside split work for him here in the Ski GP class. Helm still in that second place, followed by the 106 of Hurricane Hegg. Jordan Carroll in the four spot. Blockhead rounding out your top five on the 94. McCluggage with about a half lap to go here before he's got the top qualifying spot here in the Pro-Am Ski GP. Once again, we need race number 8, the Runabout GP class. Please report to the starting line. Runabout GP, please report to the starting line. Freestylers, stand by.
Well, Mike, you called it as McCluggage commanding lead as he comes off that last buoy. He's going to pick up the win in the qualifier. Again here, though, this is a qualifying race, so he's going to have the best spot online.
Hey, by the way, do we got any Naples locals here? How about it for one of your own, the Mac Attack, Chris McCluggage? I see a proud mother and father over there, Rich and Helen, working their way from the stands to go say congratulate their son. I see the brother over here, Ricky. Derek Helm coming through in second place all the way from Liberty Lake, Washington. Bill Haig out of Apex, North Carolina in third. Jordan Carroll and Josh Block will round out your top five here in the Pro-Am Ski GP. Coming up next, Pro-Am Runabout GP race number 8. And it'll be the final closed course race of the morning, and then we'll go into our freestyle. We'll start with our amateur freestyle, second moto, and the first moto of pro freestyle. Hey, by the way, once again, we need all freestylers, amateur and pro. We need you down in front of the stage. Once again, all freestylers, as soon as this race takes off, we're going to need you down in front of the stage. How you doing, Sophie? Nice to see you, girl.
Well, Mike, we're going to switch gears. We're going to go away from the ski GP, and we're going to go to the Pro-Am Runabout GP. So basically GP means just about anything can go underneath that hood, as they're completely modified machines.
Exactly. However much money you got can go, you can go that much faster. Uh-oh. It looks like we've got another Jet Lift T-shirt cannon giveaway.
Jet Lift T-shirt cannon giveaway. Looks like we got 3 or 4 shirts going to be shot off right here. Hey, kids, you're going to want to set your eyes down here on the end of the beach as we're going to shoot off another T-shirt right now.
And you can see all the kids running from far and wide to make their way down here.
Oh, here comes the kid that jumped and took the one from the girl. He's in it again, but he did give it away, so we'll give him credit.
He gave it back to the girl. Uh-oh, there we go. Oh, look at this one. This one's going a long way. Back, 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 back. Oh, and Tony the Tornado comes up with one for his daughter. How about that? He bops his kid in the head and gives it to his daughter. That's a good dad right there.
Well, she's the princess, and he's a hoodlum.
All right, here comes the rest of the Grommet Patrol. It's the Grommet Militia. Here we go, fire in the hole. Oh!
Almost to the tower.
Oh! Oh, I almost had that one. Almost took out Rick's camera. Hey, I believe we've got one more. As I see Brian from Jetlift Brian. He's stuffing the cannon. Here we go, are you ready? Fire in the hole! Oh, yeah, I got it. Back, 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 back. Oh, right on the umbrella, down into the cooler. And right there underneath the stands.
Oh, it went all the way under. My kids are diving through the stands. No one has it yet.
Oh.
The kid with the longest arms got that one.
The kid with the longest arms got that one. That's right. String Bean, we'll call him. Way to go. Way to go, String Bean. All right, Pro-Am Runabout GP, they're getting them all in the gate, all 8 in the gate.
Well, the Jet Lift T-shirt cannon, obviously a success there. People diving all over the folks trying to get the free T-shirts. They got to make sure they go out there and check out some of the product as well. The absolute best in the industry, Mike.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. They've also got not only their product down there, but they've got great hats like you got on today. They got shirts. They got all kind of cool stuff. They got these billet bottle openers. I don't know if you've seen any of the billet bottle openers, but I believe they got a special down there. Like you can get like a hat, a shirt, and a billet bottle billet bottle opener, all kinds of stuff. And they got like a special like combo deal. So stop on down there, talk to Birthday Brian, not Jet Lift Brian, but Birthday Brian, and see what kind of deal they'll give you down to Jet Lift.
Well, what do you think, Mike? We're switching gears here. We're going to Pro-Am Runabout GP. You ready to run down the order?
Let's do this. Boat number one from Fern Park, Florida, 16 years fast. A privateer out there, Josh Kraft.
Out of Naples, Florida, we've been talking about the family a lot here. Riding for Sea-Doo, Jet Tribe, HydroTurf, Riva, WRT, Nutrition Elite, and Inked Vinyl. On the number four machine, Erminio Iantosca.
Boat number 21 from Charleston, West Virginia. Riding for Hidden Trails Motorsports, Black Star, DEI, Jet Tribe, Riva, and Engine Tech Superchargers, Trey Frame.
And out of Lindale, Georgia, riding on the Yamaha for Team Carey's R&D Racing, Extreme Propulsion, X4, Stan Hightower.
Boat number 149 from Bellevue, Florida, riding for Hidden Trails Motorsports, the C2X team, and Jet Tram, Tim Ducat.
Out of Claremont, Florida, riding for Fly Racing, Jet Lift, Riva, Black Tip, Sea-Doo, and Oztech Racing. On 247, Dylan Osborne.
Boat number 502 out of Catawba, North Carolina, riding for Factory Yamaha, Fly, Champion Power Sports, and Dean's team. It's Brian Baldwin.
And out of West Palm Beach, Florida, riding on the Kawasaki, for Kawasaki, Riva, Fly, Quakey Sense, and Jet Ski World on the 911. Give it up for Eric Francis.
All right, that rounds out your field of competitors, ladies and gentlemen. Again, we've got the Pro-Am Runabout GP coming up next. After that, we've got Amateur Freestyle Moto number 2, and then Pro Freestyle Moto number 1.
Well, that's the way it's going to unfold, Mike, is this will be our last closed course race of the day. Pro-Am Runabout GP, some of the fastest boats that you're going to see on the water this weekend, at least in the closed course racing. Many of these machines able to do 80-plus miles per hour.
10 laps, ladies and gentlemen, 10 laps for those of you listening at home.
Wow, look at Eric Francis shot off the line like a cannon on the inside split section. Eric Francis pulling the whole shot on the inside. Is that Brian Baldwin on the outside, Mike?
I don't know. It looks like Iantosca just stopped, though. Not quite sure what's going on there. And it is the Eagle, Eric Francis, with the whole shot. Steals that line away from 502, Brian Baldwin. Boat number four back there. I believe, actually, that's not the four I was looking for. And, uh-oh, look at this. Iantosca getting towed in.
Not good. Not good at all for the Iantosca family.
Now, hold on a second. Is this a head game? This is a qualifier.
Oh, it is.
Iantosca is going to make the line either way tomorrow. Not quite sure what's going on there.
Yeah, Iantosca can be towed in, but like we said, it is just a qualifier for it's a spot on line, so hopefully you can get that machine back together and be out there tomorrow. Back to the front of the pack, though, Francis on the outside split, and on the inside, Brian Baldwin trying to close that gap.
Oh. Boat sounds like a jet going past here. For those of you who might be watching on at home, and you're not here live with us. Eric Francis, I never heard anything like that, you know, on the water.
Yeah, no, that's crazy. I mean, you listen to that machine come down the front straightaway. It sounds like something unbelievable. It doesn't even sound like a personal watercraft.
All right, and you can see him battling down the back straightaway. It's a Kawasaki-Yamaha battle right now, and it is Kawasaki out in front with the Eagle, Eric Francis, landing here at Sugden Regional Park in Naples, Florida. But look at Baldwin. Baldwin carving it up on that inside split, and it's going to be tight. It is going to be tight. Baldwin is looking good right here. Look at the Yamaha stealing the line away.
Oh, Baldwin came off that inside split section, coasted out a little bit. He took the line away from Francis. Francis was trying to carry the momentum, and Baldwin said, no, I don't think so.
Say a qualifier, my donkey. My goodness. So Brian Baldwin, the tweaker, moves out in front. The Eagle slides back to second. And I believe that is Stan Hightower back there in third out of Lindale, Georgia. Hightower already picking up two world championship titles a little earlier this week. Tim Ducat up there, I believe, into that fourth place position. But, man, watching those two battle, they're starting to put a little real estate between them and third place. Ducat all by himself down the back straightaway.
Look at Brian Baldwin. After he made that aggressive move off the inside split section and that last time they went into the double red side by side, he and Eric Francis, now Baldwin has half of a front straightaway lead over Eric Francis.
Man, aggressive. That is putting it lightly. Battle of the manufacturers right now. We got Yamaha, Kawasaki, Yamaha, Sea-Doo. Got Ducat in fourth and Tray Frame in fifth. Looks like we got another Sea-Doo back there in the sixth place. I'm not sure. That could be Josh Kraft, followed by Dylan Osborne. And Ian Tosca pulling off a little bit early. Didn't even make it to the front straightaway. Didn't even make it all the way through there. I seen him practicing in practice, and he went out there to be the last guy in practice. And through practice, he passed everybody. So I don't know if they've used too much on that machine, if it's a game, you know, because you never know. Anything could be happening here. Again, this is just a qualifier.
Well, you listen to the machine of Francis go down the front straightaway on that Kawasaki Riva Fly Quakey Sense Jet Ski World Monster Energy Drink machine. And that thing just sounds like nothing I've ever heard before.
Pretty amazing. Five laps down, five laps to go here in this 10-lapper. And Baldwin, after getting past the Eagle, has got about a back straightaway lead, about an 8 to 9 second lead over Francis, as we view it here from the Hidden Trail Sea-Doo Pro Watercross Tower of Power, presented by Jetlift.
Well, you know what's funny, too, about Brian Baldwin? He's really proud of the fact that he rides a Yamaha. In fact, if you ever see him, he'll give you the flex like this, and he'll say, these are some Yamaha guns. That's how you get arms like this.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Baldwin, a long-time Sea-Doo rider, rode Sea-Doos forever, and making a switch to Yamaha just at the beginning of last season, and Yamaha really seems to be working out for him, not on this tour, but others as well.
Hats off real quick. I want to give props where props are due. Richard Taylor. Richard Taylor right down here in front of us. Nice race in that Sport GP, man. That was a beautiful race, wire to wire.
Ah, yeah. Rich Taylor still got it in that Sport GP. He proved that today with a stacked field.
Here comes the front of the pack, moving up on the back of the pack, Mike, as 247 down the front straightaway. That's Dylan Osborne, but Brian Baldwin off the outside split section. He's going to be catching him in just another half a lap or so.
Baldwin showing you some Dean's team power down the front straightaway, riding on that factory Yamaha. And it's you know what that sounds like? It sounds like a Hoover sweeper. It sounded like when I was young and I was growing up, that sounded like my mom was sweeping in the living room. And I'd be like, Mom, come on, man, I'm watching TV.
Yeah, that was back when they used to make sweepers loud because housewives thought that they worked better then.
Yeah.
Seriously, that's the truth.
The louder they were, the better it sucked. All righty, once again, Baldwin into the outside split. And again, not too much time left to go. Dylan Osborne, the Hydro Drag boat captain from last week, watching them guys go 107.9 miles per hour from start to finish. Thanks so much to Osborne for helping us out. Came down, took a Monday off of work just to be with us. Had Mike Valdez of the MVP team put out 107.9. And Reggie Sanchez came off a boat at 106.5.
You know, I'd heard that you had about 2,000 fans or so over there in the bleachers as well, that the turnout was quite impressive, and the fans really were treated to some kind of a show.
Yeah, on the Pro Watercross tour page, already has over 240,000 views. Mike Valdez, they just taped one of the drag races. Happened to be the one where he broke the Super World record with 102.9.
Amazing. I can't comprehend what that would feel like to go that fast. Maybe I want to try.
That's with a stock haul. It's super stock class. White flag is out for Brian Baldwin.
So once again, this is the qualifier in the Pro-Am Runabout GP. So this is not a moto-style format. This is a qualifier. These machines will be featured on the Pro Day in tomorrow's CBS coverage, Mike.
As well they should be. Some of the top athletes and top manufacturers in our field. Looks like Icy Mike, I was looking, it's like a boat having an issue over there, and Icy Mike going over to check on it. Not sure if that was Trey Frame's boat. Yeah, Frame, if you were, I don't know, you weren't in Charleston, but Trey Frame actually had a boat that caught on fire. All right. She left all her clothes in England. Sweet. Sweet. we'll see.
Two for Mike.
Oh, my. Look at that. And two T-shirts shot and two T-shirts got right now.
Once again, that Jeff Lift T-shirt going off right now as that cannon being shot down there. Hey, Brian Baldwin, nice race. Runabout GP, Brian Baldwin, your winner. Show us the Yamaha guns, Brian. Where's the Yamaha guns? All right, then. Looks like we're going to do it again. Here we go. It's shot. It's over the Tower of Power on the backside. Down the backside there of the Tower of Power. Once again, Jet Lift.
Check, check, check. I got more free stuff. Ace man Evan Kresge, Justin Sylvain, Jeb Zarzauer. By the way, freestylers, you guys got about 5 minutes. You'd like to go out and warm up. All freestylers, you guys would like to go out and warm up. You got about 5 minutes. We're going to take care of a couple interviews up here on the stage. Rick, do we got any music for everybody out there?
Drake, we also need to let you know, Drake, we need you up here in the Tower of Power as a freestyle judge. Please and thank you, Drake, as well as Brian Osborne. Brian O'Rourke, if we could get you up here in the Tower of Power as well. And then Gary Burka, one of our pro freestylers, has volunteered to be a judge as well for amateur freestyle.
Oh, yeah, I'd like to say a special thanks once again to all of you folks who are listening in on a Visit West Virginia live stream from around the world. It's been a great time being your host up here with Mike Remar. I'd like to say a special hello to our good friend and colleague who is over in China right now, though, Miss Dawn Dawson. We miss you, Dawn. Wish you were here in Naples, but we understand why you're in China. Lots of love from the Tower of Power, baby.
And O'Rourke, needed in the Tower of Power as freestyle judge. Hey, just letting you know, folks, we're going to take a timeout here real quick as we got Fox News 4 in the house. Fox News 4 in the house, and they are going to do an interview. Freestyle guys, if you hear me down there, if you get in the water and go out right now, it would actually make for a really awesome interview. Mike Young being interviewed by Fox News 4. In the water, guys. Freestyle guys, amateur and pro, in the water, in the background. Yeah, I know. You know how it is. We're working with TV here, man. How cool would it be for you to be in the background doing flips and all that stuff while Mike's being interviewed by Fox News 4? I think that's cool. Once again, Brian O'Rourke, if you could make your way to the Tower of Power, we need you as a freestyle judge, please and thank you.
This fucking dipshit.
Even better.
cast over there.
Attention in the pits, attention in the pits. We need Chris McCluggage. Chris McCluggage, if you could, please report to the stage. We've got Fox 4 up here, and we need to talk to you. Once again, Chris McCluggage, if we could get you to come up to the stage, we appreciate it. Thank you.
Brian O'Rourke, Brian O'Rourke, if we could have you report to the Tower of Power. Brian O'Rourke, to the Tower of Power, please. We're ready for freestyle, baby.
Yeah. Time to go big. Got some great freestylers here, both in our amateur and our pro classes.
Saw that. I know. I'm a big fan.
Big fan of the squash.
Once again, Chris McCluggage, we need you to the stage. Chris, if you could come up to the stage, we appreciate it.
Champions. Okay, you
Well, as we prep for amateur freestyle, this is what's coming at you this afternoon, folks, right here in Naples, Florida, for the Pro Watercross World Championships. We're going to have the second moto of our amateur freestyle. So what we did is yesterday, all these freestyle competitors in the amateur series ran their first moto. They were given scores, and they were given points based on their finish. This will be the second moto today, and what's going to happen is each of them is going to have 2 minutes. 2 minutes to be able to put together the best routine that they can, and that's going to include the number of tricks done in the two-minute routine, the degree of difficulty done in that two-minute routine, as well as something that we call amplitude. And amplitude is that innate ability to be a showman and actually put together a show, so the fluidity of the tricks, kind of the crowd appeal, all that sort of thing, that's called amplitude. And we're going to get ready to do that here in just a couple of seconds. So what we're going to do here today, folks, is we're going to have the competitors go in the reverse order of how you actually finished yesterday. So if you were fourth yesterday, you'll be going first. So that means that Jeb Zarzauer will be our first competitor in amateur freestyle. We'll have him go off in just a couple of minutes. Guys, still trying to line up the judges, get everything ready to go here. How about it, Naples, Florida? You ready for some freestyle? Oh, really?
Whoa.
Really? How about it? Come on, Naples, Florida. You ready for some freestyle? Let's get loud. Let's get obnoxious over here in the style. Okay, that's more like it. Can you believe that, Mike? Can you believe that?
I cannot believe that. I'm ready for some freestyle. Hey, and by the way, just as a reminder to you freestylers, you see Mike Root, who is over here just on this side of the beach. Mike will be holding up a yellow flag at 15 seconds and a red flag at 2 minutes, okay? Do you got that? Once again, Mike Root, your course marshal, will hold up a yellow flag at 15 seconds and a red flag at 2 minutes. Hey, freestylers, did you hear me? Hey, Justin Sylvain, what did I just say? Exactly. See, you got to be in the know. They're going to hold up a yellow flag from there at 15 seconds, a red flag at 2 minutes, okay? And you got Mike Root that's going to be out there with you guys. We still have a whistle, no horn, okay?
And Mike Root, you'll go on my whistle, right? So when I blow that whistle, that'll let you know that it's 15 seconds. When I blow it with a whole bunch of blasts in a row, that will be the end of the routine. All good?
All right. I'm ready. Are you ready? I said, are you ready? Yeah, okay, let's get our first freestyler out there, ladies and gentlemen. He is out of Raleigh, North Carolina. He'll be competing today on a DVX. How about a nice warm welcome for Jeb Zarzauer?
So again, guys, just like we said yesterday, your first trick is going to signify the beginning of your routine. Looks like Nick Handler down there setting them straight.
It was on there. That's all right. Hey, Jeb, time to go.
Your first trick is going to indicate that you are on the clock. So that first trick will put you on the two-minute clock there, guys.
By the way, folks, don't forget to stop at the Pro Watercross merchandise booth sometime during the break here and pick up yourself a Pro Watercross t-shirt. It only costs you $15. They've also got DVDs down there. They got bomber eyewear. They got Jeb Renew. They got all kind of stuff down there. Again, that is at the Pro Watercross Tour merchandise booth just on the right-hand side of camera tower number one.
All right, so yesterday Jeb Zarzauer finished fourth in the amateur freestyle competition. So that means that he's going to be the first competitor today. He wants to hear it, folks. If you like what you see, if you're digging some amateur freestyle, let them know. Get loud, get obnoxious. The louder you guys get, the crazier these guys will get. They're not playing with a full deck anyway.
Yeah, definitely missing their threes and eights.
Looking back to cut across his own way. Going to go with a big aerial right off the bat. He is on the clock, Mike.
All right, we're starting off with a 360 flat spin. And again, he's on an X-Scream DVR boat, or DVX boat, rather. There we go. Get in the pocket, and a nice backflip there. Lands it solidly. Again, folks, if you see something you like, put your hands together. As Mike had pointed out, the louder you guys get, the crazier they're going to get out there. The crazier we're going to get up here, too. Circle up. 360 flat spin into 180. into a backflip, showing you a little horsepower there, Mike Remar.
Well, he really did a nice job. He pulled that 360, spun around the flat spin, and then, yeah, had all the horsepower he needed to pull off a complete backflip. He wasn't short on that at all.
Now, these boats right here, a lot of bottom end. You're probably not going to find one of these freestyle boats out here today that you can pick up for less than $25,000. And that's a light estimate on most of them. All right, so wasting a little bit of time here. What do you think? Jeb is, well, this is the amateur class. The judges are looking for degree of difficulty. They're looking for how fluent you go between trick and trick, how big you go, your amplitude.
Well, he wanted that wave, and it didn't quite work out for him. He didn't time it right. Comes into this one with a big backflip and a second backflip into a nose stall. Now, he tried that one-legged, Mike.
Yeah, it looked like he was going for a one-legged backflip, come up just a little bit short. Come on, folks, let's get behind Jeb right now. Put your hands together for him.
Well, dismounted from the machine, and I think that machine is not running right now, Mike. So he's going to have to get back out and try to pull off as many stunts as he can, as he's falling behind a number of tricks.
15 seconds right here. All right, not too much time left to go. About 7 seconds left. Oh, and a Ghost Rider 360. I don't know if he meant to do the Ghost Rider 360, but that's what he did. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a nice round of applause for him?
Yeah, he might be hurt. We're going to get our course marshal there. That's a very slow swim back to the machine. Yeah, he's not feeling very good. He came off that machine on that big rotation, Mike. That was big. He went big, and I don't think he's feeling real well.
All right, and once again, we'll do this the same way that we did it yesterday. Our judges will give us the scores up here, and then we'll let you know at the end what everybody's total scores were.
Well, we're getting the scores there as we calculate the scores on that. That means that our next competitor, the Iceman, going to be up next. So, the Iceman, we need you prepping to go into the water as you'll be competitor number two. Our course officials attending to the official or attending to Zarzar down there as he went big, went for the big spin, the flat rotation, came off the machine, and as Mike called it, the Ghost Rider full rotation flat spin.
Yeah, Ghost Rider 360, you know, that's the first time I've seen one of those. But I'll tell you what, it was pretty exciting for all of us. Hopefully he's all right and his boat's all right.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, how about you put your hands together for Jeb Zarzar as he went big, man. He sacrificed his body to put on a show for you. Nice one, Zeb. The Ghost Rider 360, I like that, Mike.
Well, we're just calling it as we see it up here, and unfortunately, you get the name of tricks, and actually, sometimes they become tricks, you know. Accidents can become tricks, and that's what freestyle is all about. It's about putting together your originality and enthusiasm, and combining that with all the things that go to impress our judges that are up here on the tower. Well, we've got our scores up here, and we're ready for our second rider. Mike?
Well, the Iceman hopping on that machine now as he's out there. Now, Mike, you said yesterday he used to be in a band overseas, and he was rocking it out, and he's gone from being a band leader to being a freestyle leader.
Yeah, I mean, thousands used to flock and swarm to see this guy. I mean, just like the Backstreet Boys, they had a group over there that was very similar from the Czech Republic, and this guy traveled all over Russia and all over Europe. And he was like basically like one of the Beatles over there, man. Crazy, crazy stuff. Nice one, Nikki. Nice dismount, Nikki. Oh, it was the T-Boys. It was the T-Boys. That was the name of his band over there. Little trivia, the T-Boys. Yeah, you can Wikipedia it.
Well, the Iceman wants to hear it here as he's running around that swim buoy down there. I tell you what, folks, you like what you see. Get loud. Get obnoxious. This is part of the showmanship right here as he's trying to play the crowd. The Iceman will be on the clock when he pulls off his first trick.
All right, here we go. Nice little setup wake for the Iceman. Oh, nice big amplitude backflip. And says, how you like me now? And there we go, off access 360 into a backflip, into a 360. Let's make it another one. How about a backflip? How about that, ladies and gentlemen? Iceman, breaking the ice here.
Definitely put a nice routine in there. That was a lot of solid tricks done one right after the other. Now, so his trick count is going up there.
Another 360 into backflip. Oh, into A 360 one-hander lander. Doesn't quite get it, but he sticks the tongue out at the crowd. You know he's having a good time.
Yeah, the Iceman, you know, he's performing here. If he used to perform the T-Boys, now he's doing it here, right here in Naples, Florida. Big backflip, Mike, one-hander lander, and it looks like we got the ski team here.
Yeah, actually what they're going to do is a double-up boat wake for all the riders immediately following freestyle. So you stay and see, watch these guys get close to 30 feet in the air. Nice one-handed 360 flat spin into a tail stall. Winds it up, Hollywood corkscrew. And there we go. He's got it, man. Iceman has got this one.
Well, you'll see he's digging his feet in, folks. A lot of these guys will do this with baseball cleats or football cleats. They're digging in. Big backflip there and a second. Yeah. With a one-hander high in the sky.
Yeah, into a one-hander lander. Got his lovely wife, Petra, watching on down here. And Iceman actually put on the U.S. Freestyle Championships Tour this year with one on the East Coast, one on the West Coast. Wasn't able to compete. And how about that? Backflip into no-hander lander. Showing you a little bit of balance and control, Mike.
Well, we're coming up to the 15 seconds, and I'm about to blow the horn here as he's just got a little bit of time to wrap up his routine.
15 seconds left on the clock. Set up wake, hop, hop, up over the top. Ghost Rider 360. And how about it, folks, for the Iceman? I think they like that Ghost Rider 360 going a little old school, you know, with one of these new school boats. The judges are talking about it right now, and they're discussing that. I'd like to remind everybody, don't forget, we've got Johnsonville Marketplace right back here behind us. Make sure if you're a little bit hungry, a little bit thirsty during the break, stop on back there, get yourself a brat or a hot dog. Also got the Pro Watercross merchandise booth open right beside Camera Tower number one. And, of course, our friends from Jetlift are back here with us as well. All right, going to grab the judges' scores here, Mike, before we go on to our third competitor.
Okay, while you get those judges' scores, I'll introduce our next rider. This guy comes all the way down from Lake Orion, Michigan, riding in the SXR. He's riding for HydroTurf, Ballistic Batteries, Elusive Glove, X-Scream, Jet Pilot, and Fast Elements. Give it up for Evan Krefsky. So Evan, the training partner of Justin Sylvain, as they're up there in Lake Orion, Michigan. I love that stuff from Michigan, as I'm from Michigan myself, so giving it up for the Michigan boys. Evan Krefsky finished second yesterday to his training partner, Justin Sylvain. And they train together, they work out together, they compete against each other.
Yeah, that's right. By the way, ladies, Evan is a Gemini. He enjoys backpacking and the soulful sounds of Justin Bieber.
The Biebs. So once again, you're looking at flat water freestyle, folks. There are no waves for these guys to work with. They have to create their own wave, and they have a very unique way of being able to do that. Lots of horsepower under the hoods, very uniquely designed machines, specifically designed for pulling freestyle maneuvers.
I'll tell you, this kid's a beast right here. Look at that big one-legged backflip. How about that amplitude right there?
Wow, did you see how high he was, Mike? That was big.
Yeah, I hope nobody calls the FAA this week. And there we go, slides into a backflip. Let's make it two right there. Makes it look so easy, man. Very smooth ride so far for Evan Krefsky, Mike.
Yeah, Evan Krefsky, you know, he's got that pretty green machine. Going to hop it and pop it. Big off-axis rotation to the left, to the right.
Yeah, 360 each way, goes one-handed that first way. And I'll tell you, that's tough to come back and go opposite direction on those 360 flat spins. Degree of difficulty just went up. Now, how about that? Big 540 into a backflip. Let's make it two. How about three? Four. How about that? There's a big combo package.
Well, four backflips after a 540 rotation. 540 rotation's hard enough as it is, but then to go directly into a backflip.
Ah, nice hood touch speed roll there. 180 into an underflip, into a backflip, 180. Backflip, make it another one. How about that for Evan Krefsky? What do you think, Naples? I don't think anybody's clapping because everybody's too busy filming with their phone.
Exactly, and we want to hear some oohs and some ahs. He's trying to play it up, crowd, so let's get some together and show some love here for Evan Krefsky.
Another 540 into a backflip, and that 540 move is tough, man. He is in the air for a long time, Mike.
Yeah, Krefsky going big, man. I'd have to say that this routine is quite a bit better than the routine that he had yesterday, as he's going bigger. There's more tricks. Krefsky, man on a mission.
You know, he says when he does those 540s, he can't even see the where he's spotting the landing. Another speed roll into backflip. 15 seconds left on the clock for Krefsky. Powers into a 180. There's two in a row. How about three? Four. How about that, ladies and gentlemen? And that is going to do it. Great routine there by Evan Krefsky.
Yeah, you know, Krefsky, he brought his A game today. Yesterday, he had an incredible routine, but I'd say he went bigger. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Evan Krefsky. Nice one, Krefsky. Man, you tired after that 2 minutes? You tired, buddy? That was big. That first backflip that he pulled was absolutely amazing, and I have to say he was 12, 13, 14 feet high in the sky, Mike.
I'll tell you what, some great amplitude on that opening backflip. You have got that right. Looking for the judges' scores. All right, I got one of our judges' scores, judge number two. And judge number three.
So as Mike tabulates those scores, once again, you're watching amateur freestyle. Now we're gonna have amateur freestyle moto number two done right now, but then we're gonna back it up with pro freestyle moto number one. So that is the format we're using this weekend. The qualifier for pro freestyle moto number one will be right after the amateur freestyle, and then we'll back it up with pro freestyle moto number two tomorrow afternoon during pro day as part of the main events. So our next competitor down there online going to be Justin Sylvain. Justin Sylvain riding on the SXR. He's also out of Lake Orion, Michigan, getting our judges out there on the 24/7 live stream.
Hey, I'd like to say hello to everybody watching in from around the world. Hey, judges, if you want to wave over there to our 24/7 live stream. Got our judges here, Brian O'Rourke, Drake, and Gary Burtka, our judges for our amateur freestyle. Again, this is the second moto. And yesterday we had Jeb Zarzauer took a fourth place. Iceman took third. Krefsky took second. Sylvain took first. And Sylvain in that top spot will get to go last here. So he'll be our final amateur freestyler. Then we got two pro freestylers. Then we've got the double up wakeboat competition that you folks will get a little treat and seeing. So stick around after freestyle. We're just going to have a little bit of fun. Glad everybody could join us here as a part of the Hidden Trail Sea-Doo Pro Watercross Tour, presented by Jetlift.
Now, Mike, when we have that double boat wake set up, is that going to be like a double entendre?
Well, that's not going to be a... No, but there'll be plenty of those to be had throughout the weekend. I promise you that. A lot of them tonight at the Parrot.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is Justin Sylvain. He won yesterday's moto number one. Mike, what do we got for moto number two?
That's a huge Madonna flip. Sticks the leg through, one arm off of the bars right there. Big Madonna flip, and that's something that you don't see in flat water freestyle. You see it a lot at free rides like the Blosion Surf Slam. And look at that huge 360 flat spin into 1, 2, 180. Let's backflip the other way, showing you power. I think that guy spends some time at the gym. What do you think, Mike?
Yeah, he's buff. He's 19 years old. He's an incredible athlete. And that's the thing people got to remember. These guys are hardcore extreme athletes.
Nice underflip there to backflip. And landing very smooth. You know, that's one of the things the judges are looking for. You know, are they bobbling on the landings? Are they looking bad? But look at that nice hood touch backflip. Into another backflip, making it nice and easy. Good combo package, staying nice and clean. And again, that's one of the things that these judges are looking for. Oh, into the pocket. Misses one right there.
He caught the wave there, the finish line, Boone. I think it caught him off just enough time that he missed the pocket on the wave, Mike.
And how about that nice little can flip there? Into knack flip, can flip. And pops it down to the bottom there just momentarily. Once again, folks, put your hands together for Justin Sylvain. Doing a great job for you out there.
Well, the other freestyler's rooting him on. His training partner, Evan Krefsky, down here rooting and hollering for him as well. Looking for that wave, Mike.
Oh, and how about that? Huge one-footed, one-handed aerial barrel roll and with a hood touch in the middle, and that's huge degree of difficulty. All right, nice off access to underflip to backflip in about 2 feet of water right there. And he is locking in, and here we go. He has already started, so no matter when the horn goes, when he finishes, that's when the judges will finish. There we go, and he's back flipping away. What is that, 8, 9, 10? How about that? Ladies and gentlemen, Justin Sylvain out of Lake Orion, Michigan.
Well, I'll tell you, Mike, both these guys, you know, Evan Kresge and Justin Sylvain, they went nuts today. The Iceman, Zev Zarzauer, going crazy with that 360 Ghost Rider. I mean, these guys are laying it all on the line. If you think they're not athletes, you are absolutely wrong. These guys are crazy. They're not playing with a full deck, which is awesome. I mean, literally, look at Sylvain. He's doing a backflip in about 2 feet of water. That ain't right.
Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Justin Sylvain and all of our amateur freestylers putting on one heck of a show here in Naples, Florida for the Pro Watercross World Championships right here this day. So as we tabulate the scores, Jeb Zarzauer, how you feeling, man? You feeling all right? Dude, that was wicked. You're going to want to see the video footage of that. You laid it all on the line, dude. I am not joking. So we're calculating those scores. We're putting them all together and letting you know that the format for the amateur freestyle is this. We had motor number one yesterday, in which case we put together the scores and we had the finishes. Then today they went out on the water in the reverse order of how they finished. So we'll take yesterday's score, combine it with today's score, and we should get your overall winner and placements of amateur freestyle.
Hey, Mike, you're not going to believe this.
I bet I will.
We have a tie for first place, which is going to mean a one-minute runoff.
I love it, a one-minute runoff. It doesn't get any better than that here, Naples.
A one-minute runoff. They were both tied at 28.8. So Evan Kresge will go next. Justin Sylvain will go after him. We'll do a one-minute runoff. Again, the air horn you'll hear at 15 seconds.
Well, there you have it, a one-minute runoff. Guys, that's how it works. You know, lots of tricks, lots of amplitude, degree of difficulty, all that stuff. Kresge and Sylvain going to go at it. Now, I think they're going to have to gas up those machines. These machines are made to put on a two-minute routine. They don't have very large gas tanks. They don't have the typical gas tank of 4.8 or 5 gallons like many of the other skis do. So they're going to have to gas up before we go into that one-minute runoff, Mike.
Yeah, you know, one thing I'd like to say is on the judge's behalf, you know, I've gotten, you know, I've seen freestyle for years and years, and I've got to agree with what the judges said. You know, Sylvain had more tricks. Kresge was probably a little bit cleaner. Sylvain bobbled a couple times. You know, there's a couple things. The degree of difficulty probably went to Sylvain right there. But again, the judges want to see him for one more minute, and nothing wrong with that.
I would agree wholeheartedly. You know, Sylvain had more tricks. Kresge was cleaner. Sylvain missed the pocket a couple of times. One of the times, I think it's because he hit the finish line buoy there. But all right, we're going to do it in a one-minute runoff.
Right. These guys can burn some more fuel. That's why they came to Florida. Evan, you're good to go. All right. Once again, first up will be Evan Kresge. It's the one-minute runoff. The battle for first place here.
So here you go, a one-minute runoff. So just like the two-minute, they're going to get a horn with 15 seconds to go and then have just 15 seconds to wrap that up. So a one-minute routine. These guys got to take all of their maneuvers and package them into 1 minute instead of 2 minutes. Once again, when he pulls his first trick, he will be on the clock. Evan Kresge, coming down from Lake Orion, Michigan. These guys don't even get the luxury of riding year-round. First backflip, a big backflip into a 180 spin, into another backflip.
Yeah, that was actually a can flip. You seen his leg didn't go all the way through, but he was trying to stick his leg through. Nice underflip. Oh, and gets a little bobbled right there. You can tell he's really trying to put it all together right now, Mike. You know, you got 1 minute. You've got to do as many tricks with the highest degree of difficulty to impress these judges.
Well, he did that off axis, and he lost control of the machine. That's going to hurt him for time with only a minute routine instead of two, Mike.
Ah, nice one-handed 540 into a backflip. And again, we're talking to our judges up here. When he does that 540 right there, he can't even spot it. 15 seconds left on the clock. No-handed 360 flat spin there. And goes into all and stalls out just a little bit. Tough break for Krefsky. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Evan Krefsky. Let's get him, give him a lot of love, man. He did a heck of a job just making it, making this a runoff. That is for sure. And we'll get our judges' scores and go right into Justin's routine here in just a couple of moments, folks.
Well, I'll tell you what, Evan Krefsky went big there, and I did have a couple of the bobbles, and the machine did die on him a couple of times. It's really important that these guys try to keep the machine running for fluidity as they go from trick to trick to trick, and it's got to be tough to try to take your arsenal and package it down into 1 minute when you're used to 2 minutes.
All right, folks. I'm tallying the judges' scores right now.
So Evan Krefsky putting it all together. How about it, ladies and gentlemen? One more big round of applause for Evan Krefsky trying to break that tie with a one-minute routine, which means we're going to put it together for his training partner, partner in crime, Justin Sylvain, also out of Lake Orion, Michigan, down here to put his best together in his one-minute routine to break that tie.
All right, once again, as you pointed out, Justin Sylvain will be, you're ready to go, Justin. Thumbs up, buddy.
Once again, whenever you pull that first trick, that is when you will be on the clock.
You know, Justin and Evan, those guys travel together. You know, not only best friends back there in Lake Orion, Michigan, but these guys travel together. They put shows on together all over the United States for Typhoon Tommy. And it's great to have him here with us. And I'll tell you, both of these kids are young guns. And if I was a pro freestyler, I'd be watching my back next year because, you know, these guys will be moving up into the pro ranks.
Yeah, to a deluxe apartment in the sky, Mike. I tell you what, these guys are getting that good.
All right, so here we go. Two kind of different styles of riding. And Sylvain says he wants to hear you, ladies and gentlemen. He is excited to be here in Naples. And he is going to try to claim the Amateur Freestyle World Championship. And how about that one-footed hood touch? Two more one-footed backflips. Let's make it three. And there goes that degree of difficulty we were talking about.
He was able to make sure he rounded it off right, too, so he didn't land on course marshal Icy Mike Ritt over there. As Justin Sylvain, looking for something big, cuts back across his own wake.
Look at the distance on that speed roll. Probably about 30 feet from where he took off to where he landed.
Yeah, that was one of the longest speed rolls I've ever seen, Mike. That was amazing.
Nice 540. Underflip, backflip, make it two. And I'll tell you what, this kid, somebody get out the extinguisher, the kid's on fire. My, oh my, 15 seconds left on the clock for Sylvain, and a world title looms in the balance. 360 flat spin, into backflip. Oh, look at that, 180 into backflip, 2 feet of water, backflip. Backflip, where is he going, ladies and gentlemen? Look out, here he comes, Cuba. How about it, ladies and gentlemen? Put your hands together for Justin Sylvain, who is sponsored by Jetlift.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, Justin Sylvain. That one-minute runoff between him and Evan Krefsky, absolutely amazing. Both guys brought their A-game. Justin Sylvain, way to bring that A-game. We'll get Mike Young with the scores to be able to put this thing together and figure out who we're going to crown as a freestyle world champion. Now, also letting you know that we're having Moto 1 of Pro Freestyle coming at you in just a couple of minutes. And then after that, we're going to have both ski boats out there making a dual wake as these riders are able to go right down the middle of that, hit that dual wake at the same time, and pull off the best maneuver they can pull off. Go big or go home.
Hey, Mike, let these folks know about this double up boat wake deal that we're going to be doing right now.
Okay. Hey, we're going to have a double up boat wake happening in just a minute here with the two ski boats out there. Now, the folks here, Ski Mike, out here putting this together. We've got this great venue here in Naples, Florida. And, I mean, it's like an arena here, and it's really ideal to be able to have some great racing action here. Now, without the waves, this is flat water freestyle. So at the end of the pro freestyle motor number one, we're going to have both those boats making a dual wake. So when that wake comes together and makes something quite large down the middle, these guys attack it, go after it very aggressively, and go for the most air with the most amplitude that they can bring. Well, once again, giving a shout-out to all the people out there listening and checking us out on 24-7 live stream. Rick Ignacia here, out here helping to put this thing together. Wondering how many homes we're actually reaching today, as Fox News 4 is also in the house getting lots of coverage today. Did a nice interview with Mike Young earlier. Rick, how many homes are we reaching today so far?
Today we got about 70,000 people that was watching the races and the freestyle going on today.
I'll tell you what, Rick from 24-7, the guy's amazing. You know, Mike Young and I are up here in the Tower of Power, and he makes us look good with all the camera angles and all of the live streaming events that folks can see. A lot of folks behind the scenes helping to make this thing possible. If you get a chance to thank a course official, to thank a promoter, to thank anybody involved, all kinds of work behind the scenes to pull off an event like this.
Well, Mike, I've got the results for you. Amateur freestyle results before we go to pro freestyle. In fourth place with 24.3 points, Jeb Zarzauer. In third place with 27.2 points, Vaclav Zajcik, the Iceman. In second place with 27.8 points, Evan Krefsky, your new amateur world champion. Ladies and gentlemen, from Lake Orion, Michigan, Justin Sylvain.
There you go, baby. He's signing autographs, and last I knew, I understood he was single, so there's got to be some ladies from Naples, Florida, looking for a world champion freestyler, I got to believe.
Oh, yeah, and that's two buddies right there running one and two, and you could tell, see them congratulating each other. And I think everybody's seen that the same thing that our judges seen up here was a good runoff. And, you know, not taking anything away from Evan, because Evan had one hell of a second moto there. And to take it into overtime is something special, especially when he does it against the likes of Justin Sylvain. Coming up next, we've got pro freestyle. Mike, who do we got on deck?
Well, you know, we're going to shift gears and go to pro freestyle here. So we're going to have, out of Clearwater, Florida, riding for X-Scream, HydroTurf, Breep Graphics, SignWorks.com, Power Factor, Jet Lift, Suncoast Customs, and Bulletproof Threads. How about it for Chris Langlais?
Chris Langlais. And you can see Chris down there posing with the amateurs right now. And Chris, a two-time amateur U.S. national champion and an amateur world champion here at Naples last year, making his debut in the pro class. You're good to go.
So Chris Langlais, right here, a Florida native out of Clearwater, Florida, riding on the SXR machine, and he's going to go out there and put it together. Now we're switching gears and going to pro freestylers. And like you had said earlier, Mike, some of these amateurs are ready to go pro. I got to believe that Sylvain, Krefsky, these guys are probably going to go pro next year, huh?
Yeah, you got to believe that. I mean, just look at the performances that they were putting down. And I mean, they've just taken the whole amateur class to a whole nother level, Mike.
Yeah, well, Langlais wants to hear it. He's waving at the crowd, and that's what it takes. You know, these guys are a different breed of watercross performer, and that's exactly what they are. They are performers putting together everything they've got in that two-minute routine to impress the crowd and feel good about what they do.
All right, here we go. Nice one-footed backflip. Make it two. How about three? There's four, five, six, seven, eight tricks, nine, 10, 11. 11 tricks in a row. How about that, ladies and gentlemen?
11 tricks in about 15 seconds, Mike. That's amazing. Talk about going big. You'd swear he's in a one-minute runoff.
Well, I'll tell you what, these guys know that trick count means a lot to our judges.
Langlais with a big spin, 360, then he pulled 540, then a backflip and a nose stab. He hit bottom right there, Mike. Came off the machine. That's going to make it a little bit tougher. It's going to hurt his trick count a little as he's got to recover and regain composure.
Well, so far I've got about 14 tricks. 14, 15 tricks, and uh-oh. That's bad news right there. I hear the siren going off. So that means that there's a lightning spotted nearby. And I don't know, how much time do we got left, Mike?
Just about a minute.
Waiting for an official call from our race director.
That and finish?
We are going to let him finish. We will let him finish.
So there you have it. Langley is going to be our last competitor as he goes with a big spin there, Mike. Round and round and round he goes to a backflip. Three spins into a backflip. How about it, ladies and gentlemen? Digging in his feet. Now, when he digs in, he's looking to go big. He's looking to go vertical and pull some big air, looking for that right wave that he's trying to create. Going to cut back across his own wake. Where is it?
Did you see how he just roosted his competitor there? Oh, snap. All right, there goes the horn for Chris Lang Lace. And that is going to do it. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, have a nice round of applause for Chris Lang Lace. And I believe we need to get everybody off of the water. We were one person shy of finishing the day. One person shy of finishing the day. Burke, are you okay with going?
Gary Burke, you're all right with going? We got one more freestyle competitor to go, and then we're going to be good. So Langley's putting on that routine. I don't even think he knows that the siren went off while he was in the middle of his routine. He probably brought the storm on with some of that amplitude that he projected out of the water. Folks, we're going to try to get this last freestyler in right now. Gary Burke, a freestyler from the Chicago area, down here to put it all together out of Rolling Brook, Illinois, riding for Twangled, HydroTurf, Havoc, and Brop Works, as well as Backy Chan. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Gary Burke.
All right, once again, it's he's got, he'll have 2 minutes once he goes on the clock. And Gary will be the final rider, here. Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to do that double up boat wake. And there we go. He's going to start off with a backflip into a one-hander lander. And Mike, I noticed he's got a specialized hull out there too.
Yeah, he's out there riding on the Backy Chan hull. Gary Burke works very closely with the Backy Chan folks as he's going round and round and round into multiple spins, Mike.
Call that the Mocha Spinner.
The Boca Spinner, I like it. Gary Burke, like I said, he's riding for the Backy Chan machine there. He puts a lot of time and effort into building machines. He builds machines for several local riders. No hander lander on the backflip, but sad but true, he rolls off the side of the machine.
Yeah, nice move there by Gary Burke. Gary, I've been riding for many, many years. And we're glad to have him down here at the Hidden Trail Sea-Doo Pro Watercross World Championships presented by Jetlift. And here we go, nice little setup wake by Burke once again. There we go, nice backflip. Off access 360. Gets a little bit sideways there. And Gary gonna be final rider on the water of the day. By the way, we are doing riders meeting again, I believe at 9 a.m. tomorrow. Make sure that you're here bright and early at 9 a.m. Oh, and able to hold on to it, though. Gary showing a lot of strength right there. Didn't get all of that that backflip, but was able to hold on to it. Didn't come out of the tray, so that shouldn't hurt his scores.
Big spin maneuver there as we go back to Burke's backflip. He didn't quite get full rotation. He stuck it into the bottom, but was still able to hold on to it. Gary Burke looking back across his own wake, trying to find that wake. There's a big backflip. And a second one. Oh, with a stab, he goes right down to the ground, Mike.
Ouch. By the way, Chris McCluggage, are you still here? Chris McCluggage, are you still here? If not, Keith Dill. I need a Naples racer. I need a Naples racer. If you're from Naples and you race, I need you to the announcing stand. Thank you.
One more spin maneuver around for Gary Burke, and that's going to do it for his two-minute routine as we're going to wrap it up. Now, Gary Burke and Langley's, a couple of the pro freestylers here, doing it up right for Naples, Florida. I couldn't help but notice that Justin Sylvain was posing for pictures down here in front, Mike, as he's looking to go pro already. He was posing for pictures down here in front of the Tower of Power.
Once again, Chris McCluggage, Keith Dill. One of you guys, I need you up here to announcing. Sean Reynolds, you're also... Robert Saya. We need one of our Naples racers. Please work your way down here. We've got Fox 4 that wants to interview right down here in front of the stage. We need a Naples racer.
Mike, it looks like the folks from Jetlift are set up for t-shirt launching again. Uh-oh. They're like, you know what, a little bit of bad weather, so what? Let's shoot some t-shirts.
Let's shoot some t-shirts. If all else goes bad, let's shoot some t-shirts.
Now Shay's down here. I think he's under crowd control, crowd management from Jetlift as well. Brian's down there ready to go. We got t-shirt number one ready to go off. Calculating the handle. Who wants a free t-shirt from Jetlift? You're probably going to want to be in this vicinity right here. There it is, baby. Two at a time. Hayden Skellett came up with one of them as he dives on it. Hayden Skellett picked up one of the t-shirts. Not quite sure who got the other one. Again, we're reloading it down there, restacking it, repacking it, re-racking it, as Mike Young likes to say. And we're going to shoot off some more t-shirts. Second shot ready to go. Boom, baby. Oh, that one might make the water. That one might make the water, and it does.
All right, folks, we're going to go ahead and sign off on the live stream, but we'll be back with you here for just a couple more moments before we take off. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Mike Young alongside Mike Remar. For those of you who are watching in on the Visit West Virginia live stream, Mike, we've had a great day of racing.
It's been an incredible day of racing. You know, we had the qualifiers for some of the pro events. We also had Motos 1 and Moto 2s for the non-qualifiers, setting up everything for tomorrow's pro show.
Yeah, you know, awarding a couple of world championship titles today. Congratulations to Justin Sylvain, winner of the Amateur Freestyle World Championship.
Yeah, we just watched him go off a minute ago, and the nice thing was is it actually boiled down to a tie between him and his training partner, Evan Krevsky, and they had a one-minute runoff. Mike, can you tell us a little about that?
Well, I'll tell you, yeah, there was a tie. Judges were a little, well, they were right there. They thought both of them did very well, wanted to see him one more time, and when they went out there the second time, it was pretty obvious that Justin outlasted Evan there in that final runoff. But I'll tell you what, Evan got nothing to hang his head about. Both of those guys, I believe, will be going pro next year.
Yeah, they got to go pro. I mean, with that kind of performance, I mean, even the pros that went after them in Motor Number One, they were watching those guys and going, oh boy, this is what's coming over the horizon.
Moving on to some of the qualifying today for the CBS Pro Show classes that you'll be watching tomorrow. Congratulations, Brian Baldwin, working his way through the pack for a victory on the Yamaha.
Yeah, runabout GP. He looked really good on that. I mean, he dominated. He came out of the gate along with Eric Francis. Eric Francis ended up picking up that second position. So we'll see those guys in the main event tomorrow.
Yeah, pro ski GP, Josh Plock with the whole shot, not able to hold on to it as Chris McCluggage, the GOAT, was right there to take advantage.
Well, you know, and about that, Chris McCluggage, former Naples, Florida resident, just moved back to Naples, Florida, so he's doing it up proud for his hometown and folks in the local area.
Well, I'll tell you what, folks, stay tuned. For those of you who are watching it on the live stream, we're going to be back about 10:45 Eastern Standard Time tomorrow.
Signing off, I'm Mike Remar.
I'm Mike Young. So long, folks. We'll see you.
Question for you. Would you jump on a machine that takes you 0 to 60 in 2.2 seconds? A machine that kicks out over 180 horses.
Yes. Yeah, so 0 to 60 in just over 2 seconds. This should be a whole lot of fun.
We'll see if experience or those young guys will take home that world championship today.
Are off and away.
Watercraft, they can reach speeds of 85 to 90 miles per hour. These are the fastest watercraft on the entire series.
They rate from 0 to 60 or 65 miles an hour in 2.3 seconds.
Got your attention now? Well, so will these guys. This is Pro Watercross, and it's next on CBS.
Left to right in front of us. He's going to have company on the outside. Here comes 502, Brian Baldwin. Baldwin had the drive.
Watercross is the only sport where you've got guys that are out there racing machines that have got 400, 500 horsepower, and you know, we're the only guys out there that don't have brakes.
Welcome back to Florida's gorgeous Paradise Coast. The Broward Motorsports Pro Watercross World Championships presented by Yamaha. You know, this is the 20th year Pro Watercross has been putting on personal watercraft racing.
Every inch of the track is different every lap.
You come out to a watercross event, you can always expect loud skis, fast skis, and a lot of pretty much carnage going on.
Yeah.
massive lake is the centerpiece, a Watercross dream destination. Lake Hartwell is the well-planned result of the Hartwell Dam, an engineering masterpiece built back in 1957. Come with us to the Swamp Guinea. Fresh fish, red-hot music, and ice-cold beer make for the perfect ending to a day of racing.
You know, Charleston, West Virginia is sweet. It's probably one of the coolest little places to go.
It's really cool to be in a city atmosphere. We're here in a city park and basically a festival for the community to come down.
The Mac attack is what we call him. You can certainly see why. Look at this attack position that he's got.
Pulled a good lead and managed to win.
Again, congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, that is just about a wrap from Naples, Florida. But don't forget, you can get plenty more on Pro Watercross at the official website of the sport, prowatercross.com. We enjoyed being here in Naples, Florida. For Carly Applin, Don Dawson, and Mike Young, as well as our entire crew, I'm Dave Benn saying so long. Thanks for watching Pro Watercross here on CBS Sports Network. Would you jump on a machine that takes you 0 to 60 in 2.0?